Oh, daddy.
Yes, son?
We're here.
Papa?
Papa? Woo-hoo. Mama? Are we doing a show? Because it's the Wanger Show, episode 246, Cody.
Christian, you know 246. That's something that I had pulled up, obviously. Larvitar. Dragon.
Guys.
Yeah.
246, that's how much God worked when he made the universe. 24-6.
Oh, Jeremiah 246. Oh,
and on the seventh day,
he cracked the claw.
Yeah. White claw.
Cheers, everybody. Cheers, white girls,
to God, yes.
I'm so happy to be with everybody. All the Wangers are here.
All the Wangers are here. God's here. We're all here. You're all here.
Thank
One
God,
love,
God
all
God
love, quest
here.
Love. Thank you all so much for being here. Woo. For this episode of the Wanger Show, this is a show, a podcast, where friends come together, have a good time, have a few laughs.
Yeah. Well, you got to stick around for the post show.
I mean, sorry we're a little bit late. You'll find out why at some point. But, we're back. We're here.
We're back. You know what I'm doing right now.
What's he doing? He's posting for the next 2 hours. Are you on Twitter or are you on the Instagram? What are you posting?
I didn't
even
download Twitter. I screwed up.
I'm on
YouTube right now.
Okay. YouTube.com/...
Yep, and then
.com/Twitter.
I guess I could do Instagram too. That's
okay.
A good.
Oh,
let's do that.
A little bit of IG.
Are you good?
What the hell happened there?
Can we say that we just had a scare?
Oh yeah, guys. Yeah. I almost died before the show here. If you don't hear me talk much in the first 10 to 15 minutes. There's a reason why. I'll be revealed eventually. But I'm not doing great right now, guys. My throat is kind of a...
It was a good thing. It wasn't a bad diet.
Something really funny happened, and you
exactly.
like choked on
almost
liquid.
Have you ever... Because I was laughing so hard.
Did beer come out of your nose?
Yes, it did.
Like SpaghettiOs.
It went up in there.
That's never happened
to me. And went down. It was weird, man.
I've never had the milk come out of the nose. Have you guys done that?
Yeah.
This is like a TikTok challenge.
Yeah.
The milk nose TikTok challenge.
Let's do it right now. Wanger's TikTok.
With like the robot voice. The milk nose challenge. Yeah, that'll be fun. We'll do that.
Is he posted? Eric's here. Eric Strippler's back.
He's back, baby.
Back on the show.
And I have a little announcement to make tonight. Shortly.
Wow, coming up in the next hour. Announcement from Eric Strippler.
I imagine it'll come pretty soon, probably.
Yeah. We'll come together.
I'm going to throw this camera. Hold on.
What is going on? Oh, Chris, it's
we
freaking out.
We need a cam up. We need someone.
Who wants to work for us?
Oh, no, we're revealing all the secrets.
He's got the base over there.
Revealing all the secrets. What are you doing?
The wood is fake. The wood is fake.
Thank God he didn't see the popcorn ceiling, though. Thank goodness.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's upset. The fact that I can see it is deeply upsetting.
Yeah, it makes me upset.
You didn't know, but now that you know, you're never coming back on the show again.
You ever seen those videos where they scrape off the popcorn?
Yes,
the
popcorn it's very satisfying.
Oh, yeah, it is.
And it also, I don't know why I didn't realize that, like, you literally could just scrape it off.
Yeah.
And then it's just a regular ceiling underneath, right?
It doesn't have to be, like, hot water and, like, some other kind of mixture
Apparently
or some shit.
It just moves like a razor.
I think you could just,
you know?
Like, you could probably pick pieces off right now if you wanted to.
Well, yeah, you could do that. But it's a rental. You can't like.
You don't want to do that.
Sorry, guys. I ain't got no butter for it either.
What?
It's popcorn.
Oh, jeez.
Oh,
no. Boo. You pull a block. All of you pull a block.
I agree. I think the three of us should pull a block.
Yeah.
Why is the Jenga tower fresh? You'll find out.
Oh, yeah.
At some point.
What is the reason to pull a block again? I forget. When do you have to pull a block?
For jokes like that.
Oh.
Hey.
Wait, so then he has to pull the block.
Yeah but I think this one's on us. I think we should have gotten
it. Are we pulling three blocks?
Yeah. You go ahead first.
Oh, okay. Where do you go? Where do you go? From the middle? You go from the base? Not from the shadow. Oh,
he just goes right. He doesn't even ask permission. Wow.
Pulling from the side.
Do you have to go like four down.
Put it on top. What are you?
Did you put back on? Have you ever played Jenga?
What are you? Jesus Christ! I pulled a long black hair out of it as well.
Well, you know,
whose was that?
Hi.
We're doing a DNA test after this.
Oh, who?
We're gonna see who the father is. Yeah,
of his hair.
Oh my God, Cody, that's dangerous.
He left one for me.
I didn't see that.
Oh shit!
All right, that's you, Brian.
That was easy.
That's easy.
It's the easiest pull in Brian's life.
Yeah,
that's fine. It's fine.
Anyway.
So we're back here, Eric. Hey, welcome back. You do your thing. No,
I'm posting the thing.
Okay. Well, I'll do a very long intro to set up what the question is I'm going to be asking you.
Oh, sure.
So, okay.
The last time Eric was on the show, Brian wasn't on the show.
Correct.
I don't think we've done a full all four of us since, like, you know.
Zoom. Literally Zoom.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. 100%. The time
you pulled the trick.
Yeah.
Where you were here, but you pretended not to be here.
That's true. I wasn't on Zoom, but you're right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that was the last
It's not Halloween
time.
Anymore, pal.
Yeah. Where's your turkey impression?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Holy
shit. How was that?
Don't ever do that again.
Never do that again.
Heard a turkey?
Yeah. Just jerked his neck. I didn't like it. Come here, you son of a bitch.
I'm not going to do a pilgrim or a Native American. I'm not going to
do a turkey.
For all of us here.
We didn't bring that in that up. We asked you for a fucking turkey.
Can we get it a third time?
Me in line at Ralph's. I asked you for a fucking turkey.
That's how they all sound, right?
It's like Jar Jar.
Wow. Yeah. Generalizing. Yeah. Really generalizing.
You really think they all.
That's how they all sound.
I'm sorry to all turkeys. I apologize to all turkeys. So we've been,
you guys were in the same room together. Cody and I were on the Zoom.
Correct.
When you guys called Christian's parents pussies.
Oh, I did not. You guys.
That wasn't the last time I was on. I was on since then when you were in Vegas.
But when we were, all together.
That one, though, yes.
But yeah, let's bring it up again.
Yes. Yeah. They're pussies.
Specifically his father.
His father's
huge pussies. That's true. I did some choice words about Mr. Christian.
Mr. Christian.
All right. I got YouTube and Instagram. I'm on Twitter. I'm almost done.
You're going to post it right now.
Thank God.
Okay. Yes.
We need people to see. Oh, you got to sign in Twitter on Safari.
On the Safari?
I don't have the app.
Yeah. Don't delete Twitter. Get off Twitter because...
Are your passwords terrible. Saved into there?
Yeah.
No, but you're typing it out.
What have I done? Hold on.
Oh, no. Just use your face.
Oh, my God.
Doesn't it have your face?
Oh, you only have two more tries there, Eric.
No!
Uh-oh. Your phone's going to
explode.
You're
going to use your face. What's your iCloud password?
Hold on. Let me check.
It's turkey impression.
Don't mind
69.
Me. Do your thing.
No, we're going to watch you.
Don't mind
he's
me.
He's going to do it.
No, no. Let's Larvitar. All sit here. Let's all watch Eric
in silence. Give the play-by-play of how he handles.
Not even a play-by-play. Just watch.
Just watch him do it.
Click, click. Click, 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 click.
Thanks.
Click, click.
Okay, it didn't see my face.
Turn on the volume so we can hear the clicks.
Okay, hold on. Oh, shit, I have a verification code.
Oh, take it.
Oh!
Holy crap.
You have the face and the verification.
I gotta get the
Can you do it with your glasses? What if I put your glasses on?
COVID.
Try it and find out, bitch.
Oh!
Find out what happens if you even dare.
I love the visual of him typing up here.
Yeah.
I'm
so close.
I have the volume on.
You haven't even...
Oh, ready? Ready?
Oh, it's so soothing to hear it.
Turn it up, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This is what ASMR is like for people?
Yeah,
it is. It's getting me going. This is very soothing.
Then all of a sudden, it's going to be like...
Is it Wanger Show at Wanger Show?
It is, Eric. Yes, it is.
He asked me really late.
Awesome.
I sent him a link super early this
morning.
Shut
the hell up!
Just so he could solve
it. That's not the problem. I've got the link.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, here we go. Ready? Hold on. Well, now I'm fucking picking a picture. Hold on. Or a video.
Take your time. Again, we'll wait for you.
I love that.
Wait, just refreshed it. What the hell happened? Hold on.
I love this feedback.
I want the clicks. I want the clicks.
If we get the feedback,
here come the clicks.
There's those clicks.
Live now on the Wanger.
It's like a guitar player texting.
Live his guitar is unplugged. The Wanger Show. Come watch.
Hey, Phil, my amp's not working.
I can't hear anything.
I hope it.
My inners.
Can we get that?
Your video could not be processed. I'm sorry.
What the hell?
So loud. I'm so sorry. All right, don't do this anymore because it's getting flustered.
All right, my video couldn't
be processed. What kind of bullshit is this?
Oh, thanks a lot, Jack.
Oh, yeah,
Eric over here shooting in 4K.
Yeah.
To post the
I guess
social
I did.
Videos.
Maybe I have no service. Maybe that's why.
You got Handbrake on your phone? Let's get that converted.
Honestly?
Let's do that.
I did just have to rip a DVD recently, if you can imagine. I don't know what year it is. Anyway, everybody having fun out there? The first 15 minutes of any episode I'm on is just sort of like technical.
Trying to figure out the camera. Christian's worried about.
Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. That happened too. That's not my fault.
But I got the tweet out. I just put, "We are live."
Yeah.
With Eric Schiffler, baby.
And I took a photo, too. That's like your eyes are closed.
Really?
Eric's is kind of closed.
they're open. That's just how I look. That's just how my face looks like.
That's how they all look, right, Christian?
Unbelievable.
When I was young, if I would go like on a trip somewhere, whatever, and get like a caricature, my sister, they would do these like big, beautiful doe eyes, and then mine are literally just like a little like line. Because I'm always like...
Dang.
Hilarious.
Rough childhood.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's all right. I'm here. I'm fine.
You're here. You're back.
Here now. You partying? You partying, huh?
What you been up to?
Hell yeah. Well, can we say what we did yesterday without Cody?
Oh, yeah. We can announce that.
Okay, because we partied a little bit yesterday.
Dude.
We watched some sports.
Fucking drugs.
We watched some football.
For a few minutes.
Yeah, what teams did we watch?
Green Bay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Salt Bay, your ass.
Green Bay and...
What's the name? What's the football?
L.A.
We watched a little bit of LA, yeah.
Oh, wait.
Yeah.
Were those two? Was that the same game?
It wasn't the same game.
Okay. All right. Well, you know.
Yeah.
We also learned that Eric doesn't know anything about football.
But his mom is a big sports fan.
My mom, unfortunately, a Jets fan. Unfortunate for her, is a Jets fan. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sorry, mom.
Finally watched sports, and it was when I wasn't there.
We invited you over. I did say something. I was like, wait, which one of you is the sports guy?
Yeah.
He's not here.
Oh, gosh.
I put it on hoping Cody would hear it like a bat signal, and then he would just flop over here.
I will say the Washington football game against Tampa Bay. I mean, yeah, Tampa Bay, your team.
Yeah,
was,
the one we lost.
Yeah, the Bucs.
Yeah, it was the most perfect, shitty game ever.
Okay. Thank you.
It's like nothing happened.
Thank you. I'll take that.
Fumbles and interceptions and everything.
Yeah, good defensive struggle, I'd say.
the Washington football team. 2-6-1.
Hey, yeah, I saw the game, Brian.
I thought it was hilarious.
Let's break it down. Break it down even further.
Well, bring it down now, y'all.
That's all I know. I just thought it was hilarious.
One hop this time.
Bam.
Did it not tweet?
I don't think it's connect to the Wi-Fi.
Do you want
to
log in?
What is your Wi-Fi?
Yeah, let me tell it for everybody.
I must have your Wi-Fi.
Shout out his password right now.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Eric was here because we did a commentary with him, and we did it for a booyah.
A black screen.
Oh, wait, what? How did you cut to it?
Oh, we're back.
Booyah. Bye, everybody.
He was so confident.
What happened? Did he, like, share something?
He was like, bam.
Actually, I accidentally started sharing something that we haven't announced.
Oh, interesting. We'll interesting.
We'll so oh, there little... it is, the black screen.
He goes to Dax.
You got a little bit of a taste. You got a little bit of a taste.
That's my tease fucking... for the announcement later.
Yeah, but the this image is a jump scare, because I did not notice myself at first.
The image is not up yet. We got to pull up the image now.
Yes.
Now
no, the image is up.
No, it's not on the show.
What are you doing? I handed you...
There it is.
Wait a minute. Kristen's a fucking idiot. I handed him my phone to put his Wi-Fi on while the image was up.
No!
Instead,
nah, who cares?
He took the time to do that, waiting. My whole point was like, oh, here, do this real quick while the image is up.
Anywho.
You son of a bitch.
So it's there. That's the image. Eric did a commentary with us. We did Adam's Family Values for Thanksgiving.
But yeah, that is a jump scare.
Yes,
because I did not notice myself at first.
Where's that photo from?
Yesterday.
I was showing off my new phone. And I took a quick video and I took a screenshot from that.
Oh, that's where you grabbed it? That's a screenshot?
That's a screenshot from that.
You didn't ask my consent to fucking use that, creep.
That's an NFT.
Do you want to take it down?
Conversation.
Do you want to take it down?
Creep.
Do you want to take it down?
Yes,
please. He has a video of you now and he just took a screenshot.
I got an email. It's unrelated, I'm just saying.
I'm really happy for you.
Oh my God, don't make me log. I have to log back into... Just keep going.
Just keep going. Yeah.
The image is gone. It's back to us. We did do Adam's Family Values yesterday.
Yeah, it was a good time.
That'll premiere, Thursday?
Thursday for the patrons.
Wanger's Patreon.
Wanger's Patreon only. Check it out. We might have a highlight video for it, too.
Might do it. That was good times.
We'll sure try.
You guys have never... you guys haven't seen it in a while. You guys have seen it before.
It's been a minute. But I realized while we were watching it that it's the only Adam's Family movie that I actually remember.
That's right. Yeah. I forgot. And it's kind of same, I think. Maybe. Yeah. I don't know. Mm-hmm.
The first one isn't that memorable. It's a weird thing fake Uncle Fester.
Yeah.
But the most quotable and memorable lines are from Adam's Family Values.
I think I thought what we watched was two different movies.
Oh.
I thought them going to camp was one movie, and then one about Uncle Fester boning was another movie.
Two separate.
Hell yeah, dude.
Two anthologies. Yeah, Uncle Fester.
Uncle Fessy.
We learned something about Christian yesterday while watching a movie that he thought that when actors play characters, they're continuating, like the stories continue in different movies.
What do you mean?
We've talked about this on the show.
I don't think so. So like you're saying Tom Hanks and Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
I thought he was a kid.
Yeah.
I thought he was the same person in Saving Private Ryan. I was
like, it continues.
But then I was like, wait, he died.
When you were a child.
When I was a child.
Yes.
The way
you just framed it was okay. Like Christian.
I was a
29-year-old man.
He was.
Okay.
But he's like, oh, I remember, like, Vietnam was before this, so he had a concept of Vietnam. He just didn't have a concept of movies.
As a little boy, he was like, but if Vietnam was before this, how did he do that?
Vietnam was 1960 to 1965.
It's pretty self-explanatory. I didn't know how movies worked. Your argument here is
flawed. I don't know these photos.
I'm sure I'm not the only one out there.
That you thought movies continued with the character. Shit. Forrest Gump was in Vietnam. Oh, no, you're saying, but in Saving Private Ryan, he was in World War II. So you're like, that's before this movie, so it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, because someone probably told me.
I would love to see you try to explain the timeline. That'd be great.
He would have been a little bit older. Oh, he's a teacher now? Yeah. But like, what about his son?
Yeah.
Jenny died?
It was back before. Oh, no, I don't know the timeline.
He talks about his wife in Saving Private Ryan. Oh, is that Jenny?
Oh, you thought it was Jenny. So it's like,
no.
So,
is that true?
What?
Wait. He talks about Jenny and Saving Private Ryan.
No,
Ryan.
No.
He
with talks with about Christian's his wife. Concept of movies.
Get that link tweeted. So we can
I'm getting the damn link tweeted.
So I was like,
I'm about to give up and just post a picture.
What about his shrimp boats? How'd that go? He left
in
that
in World War II. Yeah. Like, where'd he get that after dying in World
Lieutenant
War II?
Was Lieutenant Dan. Thank you for your service.
But, was Lieutenant Dan in World War II? Like,
he's seen a lot of war in his day.
Too much war. And then, if you want to further go in that mindset, didn't he just come out with a World War II movie, like, recently?
He's all in the...
Like,
there's
like a submarine movie?
Yeah, he did.
So, like, you could pretend that his character in Saving Private Ryan totally negating the message of that movie, of him surviving.
So he's back.
He's back.
He's
so
back.
He earned this himself.
So...
And then he's in a submarine now.
So if you're back to 10 years old again, you'd be like, what the fuck is going on now?
Yeah. I don't know. And then if we went to the Post, I don't know what's happening.
Well, you're
a journalist now? Robot in the new movie that came out. So now he's
in the future.
Finch. Yeah.
In the future. Is it any good?
It's okay.
Oh, it's okay. You saw it.
Yeah, it's a delight.
He's got an Apple TV
deal. I'm sure I saw it in
Letterboxd.
Yeah.
What was that?
Tom Hanks got an Apple TV deal or some shit?
Probably doesn't
have. He's got all these movies on Apple TV.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's like the second one. Didn't he do one not long ago?
Tomorrowland or some shit?
No, that was George Clooney. You swine.
It was the submarine World War II movie.
That's a little rough.
The sea movie, Disney movie.
Keep that going, you swine.
No, but didn't he do one?
The first one was like a big one.
The
like,
Gray or some shit.
We literally just said it. It's the World War II submarine movie.
Piece of
swine.
Bacon. All right, I'm back.
I will not resort to that level.
Only 20 minutes into the show, I'm back.
And he's here. Eric Schrifler, everybody.
I'm here now.
He's back.
Happy to be here. Yeah, happy to be here. Yeah.
So what you been up to, Eric? What you been up to since the last time that we all hung out? So,
came together.
Aside from that,
I don't know. The only thing I can really think to say is that if you can hear that my voice is a little shot, can you hear it a little bit?
Mm-hmm. A little raspy.
You got COVID.
I do have COVID, but you guys were all vaccinated, so it's fine.
Yeah.
I should say no. That's a joke for anyone.
We're not vaccinated. We don't believe in that.
We don't. You're not vaccinated. Yeah, I do have COVID.
Elitist bullshit.
Greyhound. I'm a little
Greyhound. I think that's the movie I was talking about.
I literally said it twice.
I don't think you said Greyhound.
I pointed at Christian.
You didn't say Greyhound.
The movie Christian was talking.
But you didn't say
Greyhound.
No, but I said it's
no. You have to.
No.
We're looking for the word.
Take a thing.
We were looking for Greyhound. Survey says Greyhound.
I heard Great Bush.
What?
Biden.
So the reason I don't have... Oh, God. Now I'm thinking about Joe Biden's
pubes. Let's
talk
about it. You want to talk about Brandon?
Oh, yeah. I have a question.
What's your question?
Do you have a big conservative audience?
Oh, huge. Totally. Yeah.
Why the fuck
are you saying let's go Brandon instead of fuck Joe Biden? Just say fuck Joe Biden.
Because the First Amendment like prevents you from saying what you really want.
No, that's the opposite.
Is that the opposite? Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Fuck Donald Trump and fuck Joe Biden.
Yeah.
Like, what? You can say both.
We can say that. We're in America.
This is America.
Oh, shit.
You can say whatever.
I don't really like either of them. So fuck both of them.
Sarcastic encouragement.
I will say. Did you find us hiding behind anything? We just said fuck Donald Trump. And you can also say fuck Joe Biden.
You said that. I say let's go, Brandon.
That's
gonna be safe. Gonna be safe.
Gonna be safe.
Brandon would never... No, Brandon did fart on someone, so...
I saw that.
Hell
smelled
yeah.
That.
You smelled that.
No, but really, though, unrelated to this, my voice is a little shot.
Oh, yeah. You're at a Trump rally. Yeah,
because I was at a Trump rally, yelling, let's go, Brandon, because I was too afraid to say fuck. I was too afraid to say the word fuck.
Yeah.
But I had a date on Saturday.
Oh,
too much making out. You lose your voice.
So yeah. Sucked my voice out. No, but it was so loud in there. It's a great piano bar in Hollywood called Tramp Stamp Grannies.
Tramp Stamp Trannies is what Christian called it. That's what Christian called it.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I did not.
You can't say that.
Either way,
called it off the mic.
Doesn't make it funny.
Look, Eric's laughing.
You can't say that, guys.
It's not my show.
You're such an idiot.
Do we still have Manscaped?
You're such an asshole.
Oh, Manscaped's online.
Yeah.
They're saying we're out.
Yeah.
That
was an accident and not intentional, right, Brian?
Yeah, Brian.
That's what happened.
Let's go, right. Brian.
That didn't happen. No.
It never happened.
Point is, though, it was
we lost Manscaped because of that.
I also don't even have a story. It was so loud that I had to yell at her the whole night, and I don't have a voice.
Oh, wow.
Well, I'm glad we got there.
Great story.
That was the whole thing.
That was not worth it.
I have an announcement.
Oh.
Should we do this now or no?
Yeah, right after that.
Yeah.
That's a perfect setup for it.
I guess let's wait a few minutes. Yeah.
Oh, Brian said that thing off air.
I did.
Let's play it. Let's play the announcement.
Anyway.
Yeah. So
I'm not going to be here, by the way. When I leave in an Uber, the three of them are going to talk about that.
Oh, yeah. What? I'm going to make,
how'd you put your glasses
I'm gonna
on?
Brian,
we're going to talk about
it. Oh, I want to see what the conversation is.
Oh, no.
No, it's just be like, that was stupid.
Oh, yeah.
That was really stupid and not funny.
Yeah.
Anywho.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm reading the.
I thought you were staring at Christian the entire time.
I don't know what you want.
Yeah. You thought I was looking at like, I turned
you're
around to
at
face
him.
Christian.
Just like, say, like, what are you going to say, Christian?
I'm literally reading the conversation.
Anyway,
all right.
So
how's everybody doing out there? How's everybody? Can we get,
yeah,
can we get a tiger in the chat?
Oh, yeah.
I lost my voice. Yeah, oh, my voice is kind of shy right now because
it's great
of
that.
That
your
all the commentary.
No, that's what I'm thinking is like, and then also we did a commentary yesterday, so I had to talk. So I feel like I'm like I have no ability to recover.
Oh,
so we're making you talk even more now.
Yeah.
Well, you know, you're not supposed to when your voice is shy. The whole point is you're supposed to
rest it.
You're like, yeah, if you're going to
lemon,
like, if you're gonna like, you can do like vocal warm ups if you're gonna sing or something. But like, if you're that's to prepare yourself to sing. If your voice is already shot, you're not supposed to do anything. You're supposed to not talk at all.
Yeah, you're supposed to rest it.
Yeah, so here I am.
So you're back. Did you do commentary for Tiger King? The new season?
It's not out yet.
Comes out
Wednesday.
Oh, I thought it was like
you
premiering
fucking swine.
And shit.
Comes out Wednesday.
No, you tiger. I don't know.
Oh, right. We got tigers in the chat. Thank you, everybody.
Oh, shit, there's a lot of tigers in
Let's
there.
Let's go, everybody. Grr. Let's go.
Don't fuck with tigers, baby.
Let's get some rars.
Rars.
Rars are back.
R-A-W-R?
Yeah.
R-A-W-R. Absolutely. Yeah. I did go to Emo Night Vegas, and my voice was shot there as well. There's a
tradition. Oh, no, that wasn't the one you sent a video of some band playing Linkin Park.
Yeah, that was in Nashville.
That wasn't in Vegas.
That was in Nashville the other day. And I did send that to you because I was like, you guys got to get out of here.
To Nashville. Let me be.
Tonight.
Let me go right now. Let me get to LAX and fly to Nashville to hear this B-level band.
You like didn't like it. I thought they did a good job.
Yeah. Do you have the video?
I bet I do. Should I play
Can
it?
Can we play it
I
through?
I can play it. I'll play it. Hold on.
If it takes as long as it took you to tweet the link.
No, I've got it.
Yeah,
hey,
we'll see.
Don't be fucking sassy.
I'm just saying.
Don't be sassy.
I don't mean it angrily.
No,
I think Christian would have to play it through his phone if we can
you
hear
do have
it.
To
oh, do you
want to
play
Bluetooth?
It properly? Because I can just play it through my microphone.
That is
we can do that too.
I don't want to do that. Hey, I sang this song.
maybe we should have gotten the Bluetooth right.
But also, I want to see because I'm pretty sure I want to see what you said when I texted it to you guys because you were immediately like, fuck this or something. Hold on, I got to see this.
I was saying, like, that's the worst thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah. But I want to hold on. Where the hell is it?
Eric said it to us, like, guys, check it out. They sang our song. I just like, fuck this.
Yeah, what did you?
That wasn't good.
Yeah. You wrote back with a period. You wrote that band is awful. Period. Period. And I wrote back, hey, it is a Tuesday, and you said open mic night, which is just as insulting because
it was supposed to be insulting.
living their dream on stage, and Brian just saying, wake up, unbelievable.
No, I have a problem with that. Has anyone ever been to Nashville here?
No.
Okay. You had to think about it?
Yeah, no. I've been to the East Coast, South Carolina, Georgia.
Sure.
Yeah.
Nashville is not. It is a little further in, but I.
It's not on the coast.
I just went to Tennessee. Tangerine. Nice.
Have I
converted you to Tangerine?
I kind of like the Tangerine. Nice. It's your least favorite one, but I like it.
So my only problem was Nashville. I just went out on Broadway for the first time in Nashville. The main street there is called Broadway. It's not called Broadway. It is Broadway.
Music Broadway.
They do. But it's called Broadway, or it is Broadway, whatever. And I always go out on the east side of the river, which is more like localized.
East side.
Okay. And then I went out for the first time on the west side of the river.
West
which
side?
Is all right. The touristy side of the
tourist
river.
Touristy.
And I'd never been out there, though. I'd never been out there. And
never been out there.
Here's what I learned. Here's what I learned.
What you learned?
Almost no beer on tap.
Whoa.
Is it against the just law?
That's what I said.
No white claws on tap?
But then guess what? I went to four or five different places. That would be fucking awesome.
Why not? Fuck it.
That's not a thing.
Can you get a keg of shit? I think you can get a keg of it, no?
Really?
That'd be interesting. Really? I've never even thought about that. I like that.
Yeah. Let's get a keg right now.
But I did see Bud Light's putting out an eggnog seltzer.
Ugh.
Yeah. We should try that.
Eggnog itself is disgusting.
Yeah. Right. So now the seltzer. Maybe we try it next time. My mom, we could try it. How about we get
eggnog? Why not? Give a shot.
Oh yeah.
Happy holidays.
Yeah. Would be good timing.
That'd be cool.
Not that I know next time I'm going to be on.
Yeah. That'd be great if you could make it for December 19th.
No, be to the 20th.
Fuck.
So anyway, it doesn't matter.
Nothing
matters. I went around to like four or five different bars. Every single bar, I was just trying to
ask them. Did you ask the bartender like why?
No. Well, so here's the thing. I didn't ask because I was like, I don't. Whatever. I'll figure this out eventually, I guess. Yeah. But I went around to a bunch of different bars and I just got like a PBR can or bottle everywhere I went because I was like, well, I don't want anything else. If I'm gonna have something cheap, I'd rather have just something cheap. PBR, great, fine. Yeah. And so, but then I went to one more bar. I literally called an Uber. It was like 20 minutes away. I waited 5 minutes, 10 minutes. And then I was like, do you have any things, by the way, to put down under our drinks? Coasters?
Right next to Brian's foot.
Right
next to Brian's foot.
It's
here.
Not that.
But I canceled the Uber. That's right. I forgot why we did that.
What is your story right now?
I don't have stories.
You're in Nashville.
I went to one more. I canceled my Uber because I was like, you know what? It was like Wolf of Wall Street. I'm not fucking leaving. I ain't done. And so I went to one more bar.
When is that in the movie? I don't remember that at
all. Remember?
One of the most iconic scenes.
No.
I said, I'm not fucking leaving.
Yeah. Oh. I don't fucking go nowhere.
Okay, all of them do the chest pumping.
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
So I canceled my Uber after waiting like 5-10 minutes. I was like, nah. Tuesday's not over yet. And I went to one more bar because the bar I was at closed. But I was like, that seems earlier than I was expecting. And I went to one more bar because I saw other bars were open. So I went to one more and they had beer on tap.
Selective. It's not like against the law. It's not like they can't find a tap.
I asked. I was like, what's the fucking deal? Why is there no beer on tap anywhere? I can't believe there's beer on tap. Give me all your beer. And she was like, yeah. And I was I asked, like you said, I was like, is it like a local thing, a legal thing, whatever, you know? And she, because that is a thing everywhere. There's different laws everywhere you go. Yeah, every county, every state
fucking
is different.
Utah.
It's crazy. Yeah.
Fucking
and
LA
so,
County.
But LA County is well, beer wise though, for real, isn't it? Like you can't get it on Sunday or some shit?
No. What? Not here.
Aren't there certain stores that don't do it?
You can't serve after like 1:30, I think.
But there's something weird in LA that I learned one time, and I was like,
"No, you can get it whenever."
Many ways to drink here. Right?
Maybe not in like grocery stores have it. I don't know. There was something weird. Everywhere you go, there's different rules. So I thought it was a local law, whatever. Turns out, here's the fucking scam of it all. You ready?
Ooh,
it's a scam.
Is it?
Yeah.
She was 12.
What?
It's a soundbite. It's a reference.
Oh, okay. Wasn't a soundbite. You just said it.
Well, I'm saying the soundbite.
You know, that's not how it works.
Well, Brian didn't play it.
Eric, we're playing hits here. Just roll with it, okay?
I love it. Yeah. She revealed to me. The bartender revealed to me. Oh yeah, they. It's faster. To just hand a can or a bottle. And I was like, that's why there's no beer on tap. She was like, yeah, it's literally just faster.
But isn't it? Don't you get more bang for your buck if it's on tap?
I would think so.
Like, you just pour by the glass.
Yeah, because you're like buying it in bulk, essentially.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Can I ask you a question?
That sucks.
That
what's
seems
up?
Like poor
Are you
planning.
By yourself in all these bars?
Next question.
No.
Oh!
No, yes, I was. I was. Yes, of course.
Oh, okay. How do you do it? Actually, I want to.
How do I do what?
How do you hang out?
How do you have confidence to be alone?
By myself?
I don't know. I mean,
either way is what I'm trying to say.
It's not a confidence thing so much as does confidence count as like, don't care if I look pathetic?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Yes. Like, that guy confident. Doesn't have any friends.
I picture Cody in a room just like, fuck,
get me out of here.
Is there like a booth?
Well, dude, I live in a van. I'm all alone all the time.
You don't right now. You don't right now.
Have you ever seen a movie by yourself, Cody?
Yeah.
Okay. There's confidence there.
I've never gone to a theater by myself. I should take that back because when I worked at the theater, I would hang out after a shift and watch a movie.
Oh, you've never purchased a ticket for me.
I've like, drove to a theater by myself. Whoa. I'm going to watch
Do that tomorrow.
What the hell? Yeah.
Do that tomorrow.
I don't think I have.
That was like...
That's a lie.
He just lied twice in a row. Piece of shit.
Moral of the story, don't believe anything I say.
Speak with confidence.
If you recall, I watched Wind River at the Arclight by myself.
Oh, yeah,
and it was
a
really sad experience where the usher was given the intro to the movie.
Who was the one guy?
What? No, what?
Yeah.
The usher gave an intro to the movie?
You've never been to the Arclight?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. They do
like,
that.
Hi, welcome to Arclight.
You were the only one there?
He's the only guy.
Please tell me he didn't walk up to your seat.
No, he stayed at the bottom. It was like, this movie's directed by, was it Taylor Sheridan, I think?
Yeah, Taylor Sheridan.
It was great, man.
Oh, shit.
Oh, dude.
Did you hear me? Do you want to repeat that? Or yeah, actually, could you repeat that one more time?
It stars who?
Is there any is there any questions out there in the
audience? Spoil the ending.
Who's the DP on this?
Sir, I'll be right back. He goes out to get that information.
So, okay. So you have bought one ticket. Okay, that's good. At least one is Wind River.
That's the big one.
Yeah, that hot new movie, Wind River.
It's great.
I would say I definitely go to the movies more often alone.
Yeah. Personally. Yeah. When I would do it after work, I loved it. I loved seeing the actual movie by myself. Yeah. It's very calming.
There's a very long period where I would go by myself all the time.
Yeah, hell yeah.
You know what? This is another lie. I remember doing this.
Oh, my God. Let's list all the movies.
Cody, we're finding out a lot about Cody tonight.
Pull up his letterbox.
Yeah, I saw, I think, Black Swan by myself.
Okay.
I think. Oh, hell, look at you.
That was because you got stood up.
Yeah. Watching that one all by yourself.
That doesn't count.
So did your wife know?
I was still by myself. Oh.
You had two tickets. Yeah. You just sat alone.
You put the popcorn next to him on the seat.
I would buy two tickets to make it look like I was with somebody.
No, that's a waste.
This is the saddest fucking...
I didn't actually do that. I was like, I would.
That's more sad. Two, please.
I have someone else coming. Hold on. I promise.
And then it's only you. And the usher comes in. He's like, there's two tickets sold in this theater.
Yeah, they're on their way. I'm going to come back and give them the other stud. Yeah,
Somebody said one more lie. Jack said one more lie, and Cody has to pull a jinx.
I would say their lie is just bad memories. Or bad memory. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You just block out all the trauma.
Yeah. Being alone.
That's how you live life.
Yeah.
Have you ever eaten at a restaurant by yourself?
Yes.
That I think I can confidently say no. Like a city.
Just give it a second. No, hold on.
That's like this morning.
No. Like a sit down restaurant where you walk up, party of one, like something like that.
Oh yeah, all the time.
Ordered from a waitress, waiter.
All the time.
Yeah. I might have gone to like a bar section of a restaurant by myself.
Okay.
Maybe.
Oh, I've done
maybe that.
Bar top service.
Like where you just walk in and seat yourself. I think I've done that.
Oh, I see.
But I don't think I've ever gone and been like party of one, please.
I don't think I have either.
You don't have to say party of one.
Yeah, you don't have to say only this guy, only me.
Yeah, that's right. I'm alone.
I'm not going to like Roots Chris and being like party of one, please.
Party of one.
Wait a minute.
No, they're on the megaphone. Cody, party of one. Cody, party of one.
Fucking loser here.
I'm a shitty PA. You're here in the bathroom.
Oh my god.
In the bathroom. He's taking a piss. Cody, party of one.
Does anyone want to join this guy?
Please, anyone.
Sad sack. Looks like you really need a friend.
There's a question. There's a good question you just brought up.
Ooh.
Have you ever gone and eaten somewhere alone and joined somebody else?
No.
Are you fucking crazy?
No, hell no.
I haven't. I might have. I might have at some point. It feels like something I would do.
You can do that.
But I would be happy to if anybody ever did that.
I would never do that. I've never eaten alone at a restaurant. Party of one.
Oh, okay. Party of one.
Party of one. I've never done
that. Yeah. Well, you don't. Again, you can just walk in and say, "Yeah, it's just me." You don't have to say, "I'm alone." I'm Brian, party of one.
Okay. I don't have anyone with me, man. I don't know what to tell you. They're like, I didn't ask.
I want to say I started doing that. I'm sure I did it before then, but I do vividly remember when I was in college briefly. I went to college for a few months.
Nice. Oh yeah.
West Side.
Is that a soundbite?
Brian, East Side.
Is that a fucking soundbite?
You're the West Side.
No, but I do remember like on lunch break going and like sitting at a restaurant alone because I didn't live there at the school. I wasn't sure I wanted to go to college, so I was like, well, I'm not gonna fucking room here. You're not gonna make friends. Yeah, well, no, I made plenty of friends that I'm still friends with, but I was like, I'm not gonna dorm here because I don't even know if I wanna do this. So like, well, I don't wanna that's gonna be too much. But I do remember like having class and then having 2 hours off, whatever, and leaving, going to the local mall and like sitting at an Applebee's having lunch and then leaving.
Oh yeah, I would go to the mall, I think, a couple times. I think like I went by myself? I went to Barney's a couple times by myself, but that's not like a restaurant.
Where did you say? That's the fucking, wait, there's
an assignment.
Yeah.
All of us have to do this between now and the next time I'm on.
Go to a restaurant by yourself?
Party of one?
No, go to a bar and sit at a bar alone for real.
I can sit at a tabletop
alone. I've done bars before.
Okay, so then we're talking restaurant.
Sit at a table, party of one. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I want a full report.
Not even a lunch, like a 7 o'clock, 8 p.m. dinner. Where you just by yourself having a steak.
It should be like, it should be like a fancy restaurant.
Yes. Fancy schmancy.
Like a Fogo de Chao or a fucking Lowry's.
Well, I don't know what the first one was.
You don't know these ones?
No,
I know Lowry's. Fogo de Chao, did he say?
Fogo de Chao.
For what?
Fogo de Chao.
Fogo de Chao?
Yeah.
I don't know that.
It's a Brazilian restaurant. They serve like nothing but meat.
Well, then call it that.
Yeah. We wait, got the meat.
I'm going to nothing but meat.
They know. It's right up the street party from ours.
Nothing but meat, party of one.
Right here.
Back to my OnlyFans.
Yeah. It's one of the, it's like those restaurants where you pay like a flat fee and then you get a bunch of food. It's not like a buffet,
oh,
but.
Oh, you know what you, we should do? Sit at like a Benihana, like a community party of one.
Oh, that was, wait a second. There sitting at like a hibachi restaurant?
Yes.
Yeah, oh, God. One. Catching the shrimp in your mouth alone. No one to laugh with. You catch the shrimp, it misses, and he goes, never mind. And you're just like, it bounces off of you and onto the woman next to you. Yeah. She's in her 40s.
The guy always has a fake, like, mustard squirter. Like,
it's not mustard.
And it goes to the guy, and he's like, he tells it to the one guy. He's like, what's this guy's deal?
Oh, my God. Oh, wait, I've got one better for you.
No, we'll do that.
Yes. Okay, well, okay, so we're going to do that.
What's yours?
But I've got something better for you. Have you ever been to a haunted house alone?
No. Why have you been? Well, because you like travel the world
all
looking
the
for
time.
Haunted
well, and
houses.
Also, I love haunted houses, and I'm just on the road. You kidding me? You can't get people to go to haunted houses as often as I want to go, okay? Yes. I go to haunted houses all the time alone, and they will fucking rip you apart.
Rip the hell,
you're like, you're here alone? Because like, they're trying to be scary. So some like local community theater asshole is just like in like bad makeup, and they're just like, you're here alone? And that's sad.
Like, they say that?
Isn't that scary?
Now that's my fear
that's
when
more
I go
scary
to Red
than like a goblin or some shit. Yeah. You're alone.
But they'll but also they'll be like, ooh, brave, aren't we? You know, things like that.
Passive aggressive.
What's great is they'll let me in alone. If they're not crowded, if I go on a night where they're not crowded, they will let me in alone.
Oh, that's
so
fine.
Like, you know, like they wouldn't they won't put me with a group.
Yeah.
They'll
but why shame better. You? Why
they do it to be creepy. They're not actually saying it. They're just like And so but point is I go through alone and I go through alone and I'm just like
and it's not something that like you don't get scared during these things either, right?
I
like,
do. I get jumpy. I get nervous.
You have
absolutely.
To pop out of something.
Yeah,
it's
I
loud,
love it. I get startled. Yeah,
yeah.
And also if it's like pitch black, I'm like, oh fuck, goddamn it.
Yeah.
But I'll say this: strobe it's lights. Really funny to see the reaction when someone goes through alone because they'll go like this, ha. Okay.
So you look around.
Is nobody else here?
All right, there's no children with you. There's no one to
just
scare.
You. Okay. All right. Boo.
Let me try again. Boo.
Yeah. Right. Also, you'll walk through a room. Nothing fucking jumps out at you. And then as I'm walking out, I see someone like hiding to the side, and they didn't jump out because they didn't know that someone
didn't
was coming
through.
Because they didn't hear anybody like talking. So they're just like,
oh. It's him. It's Eric again.
Because the way they know to jump out is when they hear people coming in. Yeah. And I just came in like silently. Yeah.
There could just be guys like who are like haunted house aficionados. Like enjoy haunted houses.
That's me.
You gotta hear someone skipping in. I'm walking in now. Yeah.
Well, I will literally go. It's funny because I will literally go, oh no. I'm not kidding. I'm not saying that for a joke. I'll walk into a room to like to be polite, you know, kind of almost like, you know, I'm not just walking through like,
yeah,
fuck this shit.
Scary.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Try and scare me. I'm enjoying it.
That little theater actor, this is everything to that person.
But, and it's everything to me. And so I will literally walk in and I'll be like, if nobody scares me for a second, if I think someone might be in the room, I will go like, oh, geez.
Out loud. Spooky.
I now realize I should record this.
Yeah, you really we should have a camera on you.
Or at least the audio.
Wait, do you get scared easily? You like
See, this guy's stone cold. Look at that.
I'm dead inside.
He has no reaction to anything.
But me, if you did that to me, I would jump. No, I definitely go through. That's why I enjoy them. I don't think you'd enjoy haunted houses if you don't get scared. That's the whole point.
Did you go to Horror Nights, Halloween Horror Nights?
Twice in Orlando, yeah.
And how'd that go?
Oh, it was great. It was one of the best years.
They scared you.
Yeah. Well, again, the scares are like, it's more startles than anything.
Yeah,
you know? Like
it's
scares.
More
yeah, yeah. I'm not like having nightmares at night.
Yeah, okay. You're not really
sleeping.
But I'm there to have a beer once an hour, go through a haunted house. Like, I'm there for like the whole spectacle
the experience.
Of it.
Yeah.
That's why I love them. I just love the sets. I just love like the, I'm so sorry.
Rob Zombie. Oh, shit. He fucking.
Yeah, no.
Rob Zombie stuff.
Yeah, I think his was like a 3D
He had a Halloween one, didn't he?
I don't remember if it was for his.
When
Halloween.
I went like 5 years ago, Rob Zombie.
I don't know if it was.
Oh, I mean, dude, I've been going for. Wait, you're talking about the one here in Hollywood?
In Hollywood, yeah.
So I don't like the Hollywood horror.
Well,
I'll say that.
Take your van, go to the fucking East Coast.
I do. I do often. To the East. Go to the East Side. I'm an Orlando guy, and they've. I don't remember if they had a Rob Zombie one. Do you're saying they did?
They had one here.
So I didn't see it then.
Yeah,
okay.
I think it was in 3D.
Am I thinking, or is it Alice Cooper?
Alice Cooper had a 3D house in Orlando at one point.
Everyone knows Alice Cooper.
I thought I went to the Rob Zombie one, but it was like 5 years ago. It
you might have just been in like an alley. I might have on Hollywood Boulevard.
I put on the movie, and I was like, I think I'm in Hollywood now.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Well, what's more fun? I don't know.
What?
What's more fun, though? Halloween Horror Nights at Universal or Not Scary Farm?
Ooh,
or Six Flags. Six Flags. Horror Bazooka.
Is it shitty?
That one sucks.
That one you have to like drive out. You been, Cody?
Alone? Oh, yeah, I've been a couple times.
Alone.
No, we're in the big group. They knew that I had friends.
Party of five.
How about that? Would you go to a theme park alone?
No.
Oh, come on. I go to theme park. I'm literally a Six Flags pass holder, and I go all the time.
Oh, you have the Magic Mountain one here?
I have for everything across the country.
Whoa.
Oh,
wow.
I have driven by... Pulled off? No, that's not Six Flags. I have pulled off.
I think you said amusement park.
No, I
the
said
world.
Six Flags now.
Around but the country.
I have pulled off the road.
San Diego Zoo.
I have been on the road, seen a sign for a Six Flags, pulled off, gone on one roller coaster, and continued driving.
Oh,
like, that's all I want. That's
which,
all I have
which
it
one,
for.
Which
that's
one?
Great.
It was something on the East Coast. I don't remember which one it was.
East Coast.
Goliath not over there, or is Goliath?
Do they have Goliath here?
No, they have
Goliath. Is at Magic Mountain?
That's Magic Mountain or not?
That's Magic Mountain, Brian.
Okay.
I haven't been on Goliath yet. I almost went on it, but it shut down.
It's great because you almost pass out.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, I went on X2, though. Great. That was fucking insane.
Tatsu.
Nope.
That's an even better
Tatsu's
one.
Tatsu's closed.
That's my favorite.
Was closed, I think, because the Transformer exploded.
Oh, my God.
But don't worry. It's open again now. Okay. You can go on it.
As long as
the Transformers
that
are fine.
Universal.
Yeah, very cute. I see what you're saying. Yeah, well. But
that one.
Asshole?
Transformers exploding out of a joke, Christian.
Yeah, somebody was hurt. No.
Very mean.
But I, so, okay, Itch? So, but yeah, Six Flags Fright Fest, just in the background. Six Flags Fright Fest.
Bitch.
It turns out that you have, it's like perfect timing.
It's like you've ever been into a fight and then you're walking away, bitch. What the fuck did you say?
You do it quieter.
Wait, doesn't Six Flags have the one where you go backwards on the roller coaster? Is that any fun?
I know they have that at the,
like the X2?
There's a Superman ride that I think does that.
Oh, yeah.
There might be one that goes backwards. You go
no, like the classic, like wooden one, the big one.
You go backwards. Not that I can think of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, do you? I didn't go on it.
That one, like you race with the other one.
Maybe when I was a kid.
Oh, the one where you race with the other one and then you go again?
Yeah.
Fucking incredible. So. Yeah.
Oh, wait, by the parking lot.
So when you go.
Yes, by the parking lot. It's so picturesque.
Yeah. You get a great view.
You go to like Universal, you see this big, beautiful view. You go to a Six Flags and you just see the freeway.
The parking lot.
It's so shitty.
The dry hills that are about
really
to catch on
fire.
It's
really not much to see.
From a broken Transformer.
Yeah.
But Fright Fest is no good. I mean, I used to do it when I was a kid, and you would just buy a ticket and go in to Fright Fest. I don't know if you guys have ever done Fright Fest.
Yeah.
You would just, when I was a kid, do a Six Flags in New Jersey, a Great Adventure.
Jersey.
I would, you just buy a ticket and go in, no big deal.
Mm.
This one, I have my pass. We went in for the day, me and my buddies, and we went in for the day, and then when we wanted to go into a haunted house, we walked up to a haunted house and we were like, hey, do we just like show you our pass or how does it work? Because that's included, Fright Fest admission. And she was like, oh no, you have to go and actually, you have to bring up your pass to one of these, you know, kiosks and get a wristband.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm. And the kiosk lines were like 2 hours long. So we didn't even do it. So I can't officially review it because I didn't go through the houses, but I think I can review it.
You can, from an outside perspective.
I feel pretty good about the quality of it.
So yes and no.
The 2 hour thing.
Yes,
it wasn't worth it because the organization was a mess.
Yeah.
Mm. Not Scary Farm. I did it for the first time this year. Has anyone ever done it?
Is
your first time?
No.
First time ever being to the park or the Scary Farm?
Holy shit.
I haven't done the Scary Farm.
You've been to the park?
Yeah.
You've been to both?
Both, yeah.
Both.
Same, yeah.
I thought it was awesome.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. I was like, wow, this is like really impressive. And then like the next day or so, I was like, oh, they do the same houses every year.
Oh, it doesn't switch up?
They might bring in like one new one, but they have like repeating houses.
I guess.
I'm
just saying like you wouldn't, if you went the year after, you'd see the same house again.
But it's fine. But like Universal has Hill House.
Well, yeah, those are properties.
Those are 10 houses new every year.
At Universal. Yeah.
Correct. That's why I was a little disappointed when I found out Knott's is the same stuff every year, I believe.
Yeah.
Mm. So all that to say though, still had a great time, great rides and stuff as well. I would go to Knott's every other year or two.
Mm.
Rather than going every year, Horror Nights I've done every year for a decade in Orlando because it's brand new every year.
Yeah.
New houses.
It's a new thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyway, happy Halloween, everybody.
Happy Halloween.
Thank you.
Post Halloween podcast. We love to see
it. Yeah, because I haven't been to Universal. I mean, I couldn't go last year, obviously, but this year wasn't able to go either. And I love going, not because it's scary, but I love the aesthetic of all of it. I just love the set. I remember specifically after the thing. 2011 prequel movie came out. They had a maze for that.
Yep.
That one.
Did they have it here?
They had it here.
Okay, because I did it in Orlando. It was great. Yeah.
Awesome.
That was one of the best. I mean,
that
might have been coming
like,
in.
Yeah. That might have been like one of the first ones I went to, and it didn't like fucking. Because I'd been to Scary Farm for the longest time.
Okay.
The
just
first
the park.
Time. Just the park. Oh, no, no. I've been to
Knott's Berry. Oh, yeah. So did you say Scary Farm? You said Scary Farm, yeah.
But I went more so to Scary Farm than I did it. Because, the last time I went to Scary Farm, I think I was a little bit older and I felt too old to be there.
Okay.
It felt more for, like, kids in, like, middle school than it did. Like, when I went to Universal when I was a little bit older, I was like,
Which one
okay.
you felt too old at?
Scary Farm. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. It's all high school. It's more affordable. It's like for high school kids.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I didn't catch that, but I guess I wasn't paying attention.
That's what I thought.
I also haven't been to
Six Flags is like that in my mind.
Oh, really? Okay.
That's why I get in and get out. I go alone. That's why I won't make a day of it. I'll just go in, ride some rides, and leave.
I was gonna say when you
go. That's interesting though. I didn't know that.
When you go to amusement parks alone, you can do a single rider.
Well, that's the best part.
I mean, even when I go with Amber.
Single
we go,
rider? We have a single rider here with no friends.
We have
a single rider. No friends.
Party of three. I don't think they announce it. Yeah. I think you just walk in.
Party of one? Yeah, you just go on the line.
They
yeah.
spot you as you're walking up. Look at this fucking guy.
Single rider. You have a sign on you, single rider.
Can I tell you what? You know what's funny? More than one time, I have turned to the person that I am seated with as a single rider and been like, first time? Oh, you're going to love it. Because I got to make conversation.
How does that work?
I did it on the Hagrid ride recently. Oh, I felt so bad, by the way. It was three definitely like teenage girls, and I was cramping their style. Like, old weirdo. Like, for real. Like, literally, I saw the woman ask them. She was like, okay, you have a party of three. We're going to put a single rider. Who's riding with a single rider? And they looked at each other like, what?
Nose goes.
I didn't know we had to do that. Yeah. Yeah. And then I'm like, hello.
Cut to you. Pan over to you.
Hello, kids. I felt so bad because I was like, I'm cool, I swear. I know this is weird. I'm so sorry. I apologize. But I definitely, what was really funny was though, I'm such a fucking loser with theme parks. Like, I love theme parks so much and I love the rides. Have you ever been on the Hagrid ride in Orlando? Anybody here?
No. Okay, the Harry Potter one here.
Okay, but they don't have the Hagrid ride here.
No.
It's only in Orlando. It's one of the best rides ever. One of the best rides ever. And so what's really funny though is there's a part where you don't actually have to do this, but it's like, it's fun to play along. And there's a big purple button. You hold on. The way it works is it's Hagrid's Motorbike Magical Creatures Adventure or some bullshit. It's the Hagrid ride.
Some bullshit.
Isn't it charming how these places give their names rides and it's just the Hagrid ride? What do you call Galaxy's Edge?
Galaxy's Edge. Star Tours.
What's it called? It's called Black Post Outlook at Galaxy's Edge. It's Star Wars World. Shut the fuck up.
You know what I mean? Like,
we're not calling it whatever you're calling it. Star Wars World.
So this one literally says the Hagrid ride.
So no, it doesn't. I call it the Hagrid ride.
What's it called?
The Hagrid's Magical Motorbike Adventure, Magical Creatures. But so point is, it's the way it's set up. The way it's set up is that you have there's a motorcycle and then a side. Sidecar, and so you can sit in the motorcycle or the sidecar.
What do you say?
I sat in the sidecar, obviously, because she went for the motorcycle. This son
like
of a bitch,
16-year-old teenage girl,
and I'm just like beep beep, you know. but here's the thing. I prefer the motorcycle because you can like go like,
yeah,
whoa!
It's cooler.
It's so much cooler. In the sidecar, you're just kind of like you're literally riding bitch. You're riding bitch.
I wish you had a video ride photo of you going.
Oh right, I should have bought the ride photo of the three paid. These three girls just like trying to enjoy the ride and me like whoa. But so here's the thing. She's sitting there and she's messing with the purple button. And she's spinning it and she goes, oh. She happened to press it and the engine, the audio did like an engine rev.
Yeah.
But it was just by chance that she did it at the same time.
It doesn't do anything.
So I'm not talking to her. I don't know this person. I'm trying not to bother these girls on their trip, whatever. I just want to ride the ride. And so she goes, whoa. And she turns around to her friends and she goes, so press the button. And they press the button. Nothing happens. Cause that was just by chance that
it
she did that.
The timing. Yeah.
And so she goes, oh, hold on. She tries it again. And I have to say something. So I go, he's going to tell you when to press it. And she's like, yeah. And I'm like, is it your first time on the ride? She's like, I've been on a, oh no. I think she said, she must have said,
this little girl.
I don't remember if she said it was the first time or whatever, but I was just like, oh yeah. He's going to tell you later on, you got to press that button. And you don't, by the way, you don't have to press the button.
Oh, it just goes
for
you.
Well, yeah, he goes like, here we go, press the button, and it, like, shoots out, but, like, you don't have to, obviously.
Yeah, like, that would be a shitty ride if you forget to push the button.
She did not press it, by the way, when that part of the ride.
I thought it's in the sidecar.
No, it's on her side.
Oh, it's on her side.
But so point is, I was, like, the whole ride, I'm like, oh, she's going to press that button.
You're teaching her.
But then he goes, quick, press the button, and she's just like,
You yell at her. You idiot.
I should have gone, stupid fuck. Press the button. You gotta press the goddamn button. I would have been arrested.
That's when the ride photo happens. You're like, fuck.
Oh my god, I'm gonna vomit. I'm gonna fucking vomit. Holy shit.
Please, next time, just put your phone.
I should have. I should have.
Put it in your fucking photo. Pocket. We gotta get you a t-shirt that says single rider.
You know, it's funny to say that because I have thought about that before. I've thought about like making and selling single rider shirts. I've thought about it.
What's your other t-shirt idea you mentioned yesterday?
Music sucks?
No.
Nope.
How many ideas do you have?
Got so many t-shirts.
Well, that's another idea.
The rainforest.
Oh, yeah, save the Rainforest Cafe.
I'd fucking buy eight of them. I'm with this
just
cause.
The, like, literal Save the Rainforest shirt, but it says cafe as well.
I can get
Save the
this.
Rainforest Cafe. That's my big, that's my GoFundMe.
That's your goal in life, to save the Rainforest Cafe. Right.
Music Sucks is a shirt that me and my buddies are going to wear at South by Southwest this year. We were going to do it in 2020. Didn't happen, obviously. 2021 didn't happen again. 2022, we have our tickets. We're ready. Okay. And we're going to be wearing Music Sucks shirts. They just say Music Sucks. But yeah, no, Save the Rainforest Cafe and Single Rider would be great too. That would be good.
The cafe is in tiny little letters too.
That's what, exactly. Like tricking people.
Are Rainforest Cafe still around? Or are they all
absolutely?
They're went to Ontario this weekend and they had Rainforest Cafe.
Yeah,
careful, pal.
Rainforest
grannies.
Again, didn't say it.
Nope. He didn't say that.
Did not have it.
Yeah, they had one out there.
That
mall,
was my childhood Rainforest Cafe
at the mills,
chicken fingers,
Ontario Mills. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm not a fan of their food.
That's not why you go. You go for the atmosphere.
I think that's exactly what Cody said last time. You.
That'll be on the back of the shirt. You don't go for the food. You go for the atmosphere.
Cheers, pal.
Save the rainforest.
You don't go for the food. You don't go for the food. Stay for the atmosphere.
You go for the fucking animals, guys.
You go for every 10 minutes when you hear like leaves rustling or some shit.
Some fucking shitty audio.
There's a fucking thundercloud over you. Audio.
Well, it sounds like all four of us should go to Rainforest Cafe soon.
I haven't been.
I
probably
will gladly go there by myself.
Since
I'll feel right at home.
That's the one you have to go to.
Yeah, so you'll be alone.
That's your assignment. You've got to go to the Rainforest Cafe alone. But we have to document these to watch. And next time I'm on, we can watch a little like minute long like documentary of each one.
All of us doing it. That's our assignment.
We have
1 month to do it.
You three have to get another table and then be on the other side of the table.
And record you all alone.
We'll sneakily record. Yes. No, you trying to make
just
conversation.
Do it on phone. Just do it on phone.
No, you're with nobody.
Ask your waiter. Yeah. Ask your waiter, hey, can you go to the other side of the restaurant and take a picture of me sitting alone? You know they would do it. They're like, they're teenagers that don't give a fuck. They would love that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have an announcement to make.
You do. Save the Rainforest.
I have another announcement to make.
Very specifically you, not us as a group.
What if I came here with a little surprise?
Ooh. What do you have? Do I have to load something up into the OBS?
Not yet.
Okay.
Oh, he's getting out something.
My gosh.
Unfortunately, I don't have anything for you guys, but I have a surprise for Christian.
Just for that guy.
Save the Rainforest campaign.
What is this?
What is it?
I didn't know about this.
What is it?
Don't say.
That's a great shirt. Don't let Christian. Audio only listeners. It is a t-shirt. That says...
What does it say, pal?
Can I show it? I like M. Night Shyamalan's The Village.
How great is that?
That's fantastic.
You don't remember when I asked you recently out of nowhere what your shirt size was?
Oh, you did ask me that.
And then he completely forgot.
I had no idea.
He's like, large, why?
Is this like a new... Did you just... Yeah.
It's not my shirt. It's from a company. Okay. It's what I'm wearing too. Super Yaki. It's the same company.
Nice. Oh my God.
When Christian goes to have his lunch by himself, he has to wear
that. I'm going
to
wear this.
Oh my God. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I thought this was going to say, I like M. Night Shyamalan's old.
No, hell no.
I gave it a heart.
You sick fuck.
You gotta support indie film.
You sick fuck. I mean, it kind of is. It technically is independent.
From a guy who made $200 million his first movie.
That's not what determines independent.
That's true.
This is my new favorite shirt. Oh my God.
Do you like how I hid it, by the way, under the ruse that I brought a shirt?
I thought you were gonna bring up your Free Brian shirt.
Yeah. No, not Free Brian.
Is it John?
John B.
Oh, John Boyega. Free Brian.
I genuinely brought a shirt in case I got too hot wearing a sweatshirt, for God's sake.
That's what I thought.
And then I was like, perfect. I'll hide the shirt in there. Yes, there you go.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I didn't give you any. Anything.
That's fine.
Oh,
that's the usual.
That's usual.
Yeah,
ask him what his shirt size.
That was the announcement.
That's the announcement.
That's the surprise. What do we think?
Let us know what you think about that in the chat.
Well, here's a quick one.
Huh? I don't. Okay. I mean, we can. Yeah, let's just play.
Okay. Oh, okay. We have something
what
else.
What if I have something else?
What if you did have some? I got to mute all of these.
He's going to have three videos playing. What do we what
do have
doing?
An announcement.
Muting us?
There's a video. Yeah, why don't you go ahead and mute us. Take a look at this nice little promo that we have for you. Here we go. Volume 2, baby. December. That's the right date, right? December 17th. Yes.
17th. It's a Friday.
It's a Friday.
I'll rest my voice until then.
Woo! Yes. Yeah, we're finally doing it.
I can't wait.
I guess I announced it last week.
No, nobody did.
You absolutely did.
But nobody responded to the Patreon.
People in Patreon got it.
They were guessing.
A few episodes ago, Christian was like, and we might be announcing something soon. And we're like, ooh. And you're like, we're doing another karaoke.
It's karaoke. Okay, I remember that now. I remember that.
But you didn't say the date.
No. I didn't say the date.
Yeah.
We got the date.
And you didn't say I was going to do it, and I'm doing it. I can't wait. Woo-hoo, I cannot fucking
let's
wait.
Let's get a preview of the songs you're going
to
play.
No, I can't tell you, but I'm sending a video live right now I was waiting to put on.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh, yeah. Send me that link, and I'll...
Sure, yeah.
Well, let's all tweet it. It's all at the same time here.
Is he on Twitter?
It's just a little short.
To Safari? Mm-hmm.
All right, it's out now, but it's all... Oh, I think it's out now. Yeah, hopefully.
Manny, if you're here, put a link
to... He left.
He's probably
He said goodnight a while
ago. Oh, okay.
He left a while ago.
He said goodnight a while ago.
He's playing Halo. No, he's playing Halo right now.
Oh, okay. All right.
Well, what did you want to do?
I was going to put the link to this video in the
description. Oh, you don't have to... Well, that doesn't matter, whatever. I just texted it to you just so you have it in general.
I mean, you could have just...
Can't you, like, get the thing?
Guys, I am so excited. I am so excited.
Yeah,
We talked about this obviously last time, but that was my favorite thing of last year. Wow. No question. Again, not a lot of competition.
Yeah, not much happened last year.
We're happy to win by default.
Winner by default. The only fun thing I did all year. But no, it was such a blast last year. I mean, you guys had fun too, right? It was the best, most fun thing ever.
I have the tracks on my phone and I listen in the car.
The Spotify thing.
What?
Isn't it on Spotify?
Yeah,
it
is I put the whole thing on Spotify, but I separated them by tracks and I put them on.
You
my
have
phone.
Your own. Got it. Mm. I go back and listen to it all the time and watch it. I love the most fun thing. Excuse me, I could record my throat.
You're getting choked up just talking about this. It's understandable.
I could cry. I'm so excited. It's okay. I go back and watch it sometimes, and I just like click through some of my, you know, our some of the songs we did, whatever. And the best part is reading the chat because we didn't get. Do you ever go back and do that?
Yeah,
because we didn't get to read the chat when we were performing.
Yeah,
and it's so fun to see people like see what song is coming on, see who's coming. Like it was so much fun.
And shit like that.
Yeah.
The lighters in the chat.
People
did lighters. Yeah.
So going back and rewatching it, like as I mean, look, right after it ended, we did sit down and rewatch it, but we rewatched it just the video.
We didn't watch with the chat.
You know what I mean? So yeah, going back and watching with the chat is so much fun.
Yeah.
It's such a blast. Wants to ban me. Oh, there's the can you
tell that's me? That's I'm playing.
Oh my god, that scared the shit out of me. Yeah, this is the video that I posted. Did you see it?
No.
Wait,
I'm playing it from my phone.
That's
so
weird. That's the video I just posted.
Really?
That's so bizarre. What the fuck, dude?
Oh, it's meant to be.
That's meant to be, absolutely. Well, because Tiger King comes out this week, so it's on my mind. Guys, just think about it for a second. Come on.
What was your favorite song to perform?
Hard to say. I don't know. Well, let me hear yours and then I'll maybe think of which one was my favorite.
I loved when I played Drive It Like You Stole It.
Yeah, and that was your after like song,
bonus,
too. That was bonus
round.
Yeah.
Mine was My Own Worst Enemy, probably.
What was your encore song?
My encore song was Sum 41 In Too Deep, which was also.
Okay.
My Own Worst Enemy was like, it ended and I was like, fuck yeah, I crushed that one.
I think your last song was Monkey Wrench.
That was. Yeah, that was the biggest.
Because I remember you
finale.
Being like, thank God I made it through, and then we said we were going to do one more.
I was like, fuck. Sleeping with.
Let's go!
Crushed it.
I came in through the window.
Maybe not that part.
a little flat there.
Also, Emmanuel showed up.
He's back now.
Oh, man. He's like, why was I summoned? How did that happen?
It's okay, Manny. We posted. I was going to ask to post.
Why was I called?
We just needed you. I was summoned.
Everyone's like texting. Hey, fucking come back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do we want to say anything else about it, or do we not songs, but like anything about any rounds that we're
still planning.
We're not sure
the rounds
yet. Okay, yeah. We're not sure yet. Yeah.
You got about a month to figure it out.
Yeah.
About a month exactly.
Yeah. It'll be live again.
Yep. Probably around like 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. The time hasn't been.
Oh, that's true. I didn't even realize that. That's right.
But you know. December 17th, that's the day.
Friday.
We're doing it. Wangers Friday Karaoke, Volume 2. It's going to be fun.
I cannot wait.
Yeah, I know.
I've texted multiple people, by the way, and I said, hey, we haven't announced it yet, but this is the date. Like, when we locked down the date, I texted some friends that watched, like AJ, my friend Holly was watching, my mom was watching, I texted all of them, and I was like, okay, we haven't announced it yet, but this is what's going on. I'm like, just so you know that I'm not kidding, like, I am so excited. Nice. I am so excited.
Oh, yeah. And your song choice.
Black shoes, black tie with the black attitude, not me. Black Ray-Bans, I'm stunning, man. New hotness, bitch, black 600, man. It feels a little difficult to. Here's the problem. Do you all feel like you picked your best songs for already?
No, I got more.
That's,
please,
that's
please.
My concern. Okay. That's my concern is that, well, I think I told you yesterday when I was hanging out with you guys, I was like, I don't want to do. So I picked some of my favorite. I really went all out for the first one. But now I'm like, okay, well, so now for this year, I want to do some great songs, but I also don't want to blow my load, like, and everything's done immediately. So I've got some really great ones that I'm going to do for this year. I'm very excited about. And then I already have, like, a list for the future of, like, all right, this is going to be good, but we're not going to do it yet. Like, I'm always planning for the future. If you'll have me back, of course. I'm always planning for the future.
Yeah. If we have you back. Yeah.
Well, we'll see.
If we get
this. Loser this year, loser, least voted, never comes back.
Never comes back to the karaoke. Well,
even if it's a wanger. No matter who it is,
has to leave the
losers. Comes
those
back.
Are the rules. That's the rules.
We light it up. We won't come down. And the sun can't stop us now.
Ooh. Wow, that was last minute choice to go into falsetto. I was like, I don't think I can do it.
When I was cutting that though, and I was looking back at it, and I missed my hair. I wish my hair was that long. Because I looked at a bunch of the behind.
Oh, was it much longer? I
had a ponytail and everything.
Oh, yeah, you did have a long hair. It's long still hair. Long.
Yeah.
It's still
long. But it's like gross.
What was your favorite song to perform first round, Vol 1?
It was either Since You've Been Gone or The Reason. I think the reason was like the full circle of the arc that I had that night.
I don't know what it was, but it's like, shit, fuck.
Yeah. I think I put that, if you go back and listen to the
promo,
you can probably hear the, oh, fuck, because I just picked all the best moments in the background and all that. Yeah,
I see people talking, by the way. Here, ready?
Oh, no, that was all the cheer.
Fuck, gotcha, fuck, son of a bitch, that's why I need you to hear.
You hear me in the background?
Yeah.
Woo! Cheering on his bud.
Two things. Yes. Number one, see Spider-Man on Thursday, you fucking morons.
Yeah, guys.
I see people saying like, oh no, I'm seeing Spider-Man. No, you fucking nerd. See it on Thursday. This is Friday.
Yeah, right? Yeah. I think tickets go on sale tomorrow.
Maybe, hopefully. Well, yeah.
Oh, should we do a
trailer reaction tomorrow?
Maybe.
What are you doing tomorrow?
You free? Nothing. Nothing. I can do it.
We can do free.
I could pop in.
Yeah.
What time does it drop? Do we know?
Text me.
I'll just come by when it drops.
Okay, 12 a.m. Yeah, okay. Yeah. And we might be able to do a trailer reaction. Yeah. Oh, cool.
Okay, I'm down. That sounds great.
I normally
trailers normally. Yeah, I'll wear the same shirt.
You guys can stay here tonight, actually.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah, sleepover.
We'll wear the same clothes. We agree?
Sleepover.
Wear the same clothes.
Amber will be fine with it. Yeah.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
And yeah, I don't usually watch trailers, but I'll watch this one.
Okay,
yeah. Okay, cool.
No, but on Friday, on the 17th, first of all, it's going to be, you usually start on like 9 or 10.
Yeah, night.
People will have seen the movie around like 6 or 7.
Yeah,
around
the East Coast.
It'll be like a... Spider-Man's your pregame, and you can come and drink with us. Watch the stream and drink with us. Exactly. Actually, we should say now, and we should say it then. I hope people send... my favorite part was seeing photos and videos of people watching it.
Yeah.
I hope people submit a fuck ton of photos and videos of them watching it. Get friends together.
Yeah.
Get your friends together to watch and sing along, man.
It's going to be like last time that we did it. It was in October, I think, right?
It was October.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think this one's more appropriate because it's like an end-of-the-year banger, end-of-the-year basher.
That's what we were talking about. We were thinking about doing it in October again, and then I feel like it makes more sense to be an end of the year thing going forward in general. Yeah. I guess it can't really be a big surprise next year that this is an annual thing now.
We have an announcement.
You don't know what it's gonna be.
We've talked about like even a third one after this, and like specific things about the third one that it could be. And,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
We don't know what it means. Nothing to them, but to us, it's like
that's true.
So yeah.
That's true.
What it could become. Yes.
Yeah. So hope you're excited about that. Hope you're not let down thinking that it was. What anybody else? What were people saying in the chat? They were saying other things.
Who cares? We made an announcement.
Oh, we did.
That's our announcement.
Fucking did it.
Woo! Woo!
And it's gonna happen, guys.
Amber said she watched it, right?
The
first Wanger Karaoke.
Oh yeah,
she watched it here.
Yeah, she watched it here, yeah.
Just by herself.
Just by herself, yeah.
So my mom watched it all alone, as far as I know. She just, like, put it on when she was going to bed.
Amber watched it. My family watched it. I had a couple friends back home. Yeah. They're like, dude, you got to do another karaoke. So a lot of it.
Nobody from my family.
Nobody.
No, they're like, Cody,
not
you're
even
on
your
a
kid?
Not even my son. I've tried. He's just like, yeah.
He's like, I don't care. I think I watched Joe Rogan. I don't know.
That's
yeah. Yeah. I don't know what else to say other than I cannot fucking wait. It's a month away. I don't want to get like too hyped because like we have to wait a month now. So I'm like trying to, you know, I want to chill out.
A lot of planning.
Whatever. Yeah, a lot of planning to do.
Because we wanted to do, Elena Marie 10 said, emo night, but we don't want to just do like all emo songs.
Yeah. It's a little alienating. Well,
I mean, yeah.
I mean,
we can have a round.
Look, they're going to be in there. We did them last time.
Emo songs.
What do you.
Just naturally knowing us.
Boys, did we do Fall Out Boys last week?
I don't remember.
We did
My Chemical Romance.
We did start off with My Chem.
I did Panic.
We may or may not start with like a group song again. Maybe. We might end with a group song.
It works so well the first
time. Well, I mean, there's sound bites.
Absolutely.
It works.
There are sound bites from it.
We work out all the technical stuff. Yeah, it was great.
No, but I think it's going to be even bigger and better.
Oh. Yeah, I do want to up the production a little bit. Like, I was just talking to Amber about it because I was saying I might want to hire a cameraman so that way we can focus on the singing and costume or whatever it is that we do.
Our process of art,
if you will.
Yes.
And then she made the point. She was like, yeah, but I kind of like the franticness of the chaos.
It is true. So, it was very fun and like frantic.
Yeah. Well, it was fun like when Eric's pointing out like who's manning what camera is it? Oh, no one's manning this, so it's obviously this camera.
So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Maybe we'll bring someone on the Switch.
It doesn't hurt to have like an extra set of hands because it was two cameras.
Yeah, and also last year it was not in the thick of the pandy, but you know, we were
still the pandy.
We weren't vaccinated.
We're masked and shit.
Now we're good to go.
We started making out before we started this show.
Absolutely.
We can share mics, share it all. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Fucking one mic the whole time? All.
Yes. That's what happens when you have one mic.
Also, got to say.
Go for that.
Oh. They just saw it. We've seen it already, but they just saw it. How great is the promo? I think you did a great job. The promo is so exciting.
Put it together in one day.
Cody texted.
Literally, he put it together technically like in 10 minutes at the end there.
You texted us like Friday or Saturday?
Yeah, I was like, this
was your idea,
totally
right?
Last minute. I was like, but we should probably announce it with a clip. Yeah.
Did you tweet something? Did I see that? Did you tweet something just now?
I just tweeted the video.
The promo.
Yeah,
the promo. Oh, I should retweet it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Give me 30 minutes.
Take your time.
Kat sang an Olivia Rodrigo song. But I can't.
We can't talk about songs. We don't know what we're doing yet.
We don't know.
I might talk about that.
I might have a Spotify playlist.
I might have my whole list down already.
I'm singing in the shower. I'm singing in the car.
I sang on the way over here, guys.
You did.
I sang one of my songs over here. I have some.
Oh!
Does it go?
Careful. Hey, no, we don't reveal anything. Can't reveal anything yet.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So
introducing.
And I know we briefly talked about, like, if it all works out, we obviously will do the karaoke night. If we have time afterwards,
I was wondering if you wanted to say this. Because
last time you mentioned we basically did a commentary without recording it.
We rewatched the whole thing.
We cracked beers and watched the entire two and a half hour thing.
Would not leave my place.
Yeah. He was like, can you please go?
I think I got home at 3 a.m.
This was my place of residence.
Yeah.
But if
I tried to go to bed.
If we're able to do a full commentary for it.
Oh, I think we'll be able to.
Yeah.
I kind of want to try. I know we do a lot of like making up for all of our short films and stuff, but I think like the process of doing all that, if we shoot enough behind the scenes and stuff and get interviews, why not do a whole making of it as well? I think that could be a lot of fun.
Nice.
Just a full-on breakdown.
It is fun. Did we post a photo? It's my living room.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's where
yeah.
we did it. Yeah.
With a shit that great. Did not cover the entire
no.
wall.
No, no. We got to cover the walls now.
That's for upping the budget.
Yeah, yeah. We're upping it. Yeah. We're having a full background.
We're back.
I want to get
two.
I don't know what those are, but those like steel things that you see at shows, they're like twink.
C-stands?
Twinks?
Twiny.
I knew that
twiny.
Was
coming. What are you no, talking about?
They're like things on the set. Like, oh, okay. Wrestling. You know those corner
about, like, cages? The cage things?
Yeah, like the corners of the cage.
Cage!
Right, I gotcha. I gotcha.
You know
steel
what I'm
cage
saying?
Match.
I want two of those.
Yes, I gotcha.
I don't okay. know what those are called.
I don't either.
Just a pole.
Just like, well, it's not a pole, though.
That holds a...
It's like a cage.
It's like a steel pillar.
Yeah. Shit, I'm really mad that I can't think of what that's called.
I have a stand. I have...
No, but, like, hold on.
What
God
is...
damn it.
A really, steel cage.
Fuck, what's it called? It's making me so mad.
Yeah.
What it... What
I almost
mean?
Feel like
I know
on.
Exactly what you're talking about. They're like little squares and like.
Is there a world in which he would answer? Hold on.
Who are you talking to?
Hold on.
Who are you going to call somebody? Ask.
Trussing. What? Trussing. It's called trust.
Trussing.
Trust. T R U S S. I was
oh,
about
yeah,
to call.
Yeah, someone in the chat said it to you.
Did what somebody is, say what it? Is that? Trust. I said it before I looked.
What
I got
is,
it.
What is that?
It's that's what it's called. Look it up. I was about to call my business partner because he's the business guy, the smart guy.
There's a specific name for it.
Trussing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's I can buy it on Amazon right now. Hold
Let's
on.
Let's buy 12 of them.
$159
for one bowl.
These, Woo! Brian. These, Brian.
I know what you mean. They're like okay. crisscrossed.
You know
Apple
what I mean
sauced.
By twine?
Yes.
Twine was not the best word.
I don't care.
I didn't
say
this
twink.
One's $4,000 on B&H Photo.
Oh,
that
okay.
Thing?
Or, yeah.
$4,000.
But like,
yeah.
But like two of them on the sides.
Yeah, send in your super chats for our wangers.
Hashtag for the trust.
Thank you, Dead Stock Deals. I hope we can get a deal. Cody, can I get another beer?
There's none left.
In there?
What?
I'm pretty sure.
No.
Why does
I
this
felt
show
around? Can you guys see?
No, there's nothing.
Yeah.
Hurry, Christian.
Give me a second. I'll get some.
All right.
Daddy, yeah, because actually, when you go out, I might ask for something as well.
Yeah, we'll work out
your request. Head job? What do you want?
You don't know yet. You're going to find out. Okay. I'm posting that. Wanger's character returns 12/17. Targeting returns. Watch my emotional karaoke.
Is Julia your business partner? It said I'm right here.
Julia? Oh.
It says I'm right here.
Where are you
I
looking?
I don't think that's who he was.
I don't know. I don't know. Julia.
Yeah,
no. Same
Julia.
Julia. Julia. His name was AJ.
Oh, I didn't hear AJ.
Yeah.
Watch my emotional targeting.
Get it out there, Eric. Get it
still
out.
Tweeting.
Yeah, so get it. So there it is. Subscribe to the channel and get it ready. Hit notification. I didn't post the thing yet, so
what?
Can't notify.
What? Manual.
Manny.
Post. See, don't
he's
pop
gone.
Up.
He's asleep. Leave the goddamn
he's like,
man
I've been,
alone.
I've been summoned again.
Text.
Leave
he's
him
like,
alone.
God damn it.
Get ready for it. Yeah, it's going to be very exciting. I'm very much excited. And I think we alluded to it, but you're in town, obviously, for that Monday.
Oh, right. So that's if you want to say that. I don't know what you want to say, but
yeah,
yes.
Why not?
Yes.
Unless you flake on us, so it's your fault.
No, I'm in. I'm in, baby. I'm
Eric
in.
Will be on the show that following Monday.
Oh, cool.
The 20th.
Let me double check. I'm
December.
Almost blessed. I'm planning everything out. I think I've got the dates.
Julia.
Julia will be here, too. Yeah,
yeah, the 20th.
But I don't think, Brian, I think you'll be out of town after
I
that.
I will
of course,
be
okay.
on the east side.
East side. So we'll do like an extravaganza. We'll have Eric on that Friday for the karaoke, and then we'll do a commentary for it. That'll probably be the following week, and then the Monday we'll have Eric on for the Wanger Show, just full on recap.
That'll be fun. Wangers.
Hell yeah! Woo!
Cool guys.
Yeah, that'll be great.
Oh, that's it.
That's the show's
that's
not over,
the
pal.
Show. Yeah, no.
What is it? Was it like
done talking?
We've done an hour and 20. That's plenty. Yeah, fuck
sure.
No, I'm kidding. No, we can go.
That's the whole show.
Yeah,
we can go more, I guess.
Yeah,
we're going for 4 hours, right?
Have you seen anything lately? While I step out of the room and get more drinks.
Have I seen anything lately? Well, while he goes, actually...
He doesn't care what your answer is.
I saw Tick,
right
Tick,
now.
Boom.
Oh.
Has anyone seen it yet?
The saliva song?
The click, click, boom.
That's click, click, boom. Yeah, thank you so much.
I think it's on Netflix
the hive
this
song?
Weekend. Is it a Hive song? I really don't know.
What is that?
Tick, tick, boom?
Is it Tick, Tick, Boom?
Yeah,
see
tick,
the idiot
tick,
walk.
Tick, tick, boom.
Really?
Hey, the 17th, man. Save
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
Save it.
Right. Damn it, you ruined my saliva song choice.
No, but Tick, Tick, Boom, do you guys know what this is?
That's the musical, right?
Musical. Andrew Garfield stars. He plays Jonathan Larson. It's directed by Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Okay.
Jonathan Larson, of course, is the creator of Rent.
I knew that.
And
Brian,
Tick, Tick, Boom.
Yeah.
But the image of him, like, just sort of like fumbling in with so much alcohol.
Tick, 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 tick. There it is.
Tick, tick, tick.
Told you.
Yeah, that's not it.
Okay.
That's not part of the soundtrack.
That's not
opening
it. Credits.
I wish.
Oh, but I did watch it. I went to go to the. Excuse me, I went to the Los Feliz 3.
Ooh.
I haven't been in a year and a half.
Three screens.
Whatever. It was so great. Okay. It was so nice to be back. I was very happy. And because when I stay, usually when I'm in my van and I just stay in LA for the winter, I stay in Los Feliz, and right around the corner is Los Feliz Dream. There like every other day.
Nice.
Well, not that often, I guess, because they only have three theaters.
Yeah, so it doesn't swap out.
I finish
that much.
All the movies and then I have to wait a week or so. Yeah, okay. But it's the best. And so the movie's great. Highly recommend it. I think it's on Netflix this week.
Oh, really?
This weekend, pretty sure.
Okay. Do you think Oscar worthy?
Yeah.
It's going to be nominated.
Oh, really? Oscar. I could see Oscar nominations.
It's got the vibe.
Wins, I don't know, but Oscar nominations.
For acting, directing, writing, all of it. Best picture.
I think Andrew Garfield could, you know.
That guy's got to get an Oscar, right?
He's never gotten a nom, has he?
He did. Social Network.
No.
Yeah, you want to bet?
Did he?
Yeah.
I don't want to bet because he might be right. But he didn't get a win. But didn't
he's
he also,
not, he's never won.
Maybe also, did he also get a nomination for Hacksaw? That's what I'm thinking. No wins, though, right?
No wins.
No, I would know if
he was great in Social Network.
He's nearing 40. He looks like he's nearing 30.
Really?
Like, he still looks so young.
He's going to be 40?
I know. He's he's like 37 years old.
Wow.
Doesn't it look like he's like so young?
I thought he was in college when he created Facebook.
Don't be a fucking asshole.
You swine.
Don't be a swine.
Unbelievable.
Should we put these in the little fridge?
Oh, yeah, sure. I don't know which one.
Pass them over.
If we all just drink them really fast.
Oh, wait. I've never had a Michelob Ultra Seltzer.
Oh, they're pretty good. I like them.
Okay, what do we got? What are the flavors? Citrus, mango, apricot, and mixed berry. Should I go citrus or mango? Well, I had mango now. I guess I should go citrus. Anyone else?
The one that's missing, I think. Andrew Garfield.
Did everybody get one? Or wait,
I did. I got it.
Okay, good.
Wow, he wasn't nominated for the Social Network.
I thought so, because I let you have it because I wasn't sure. But I remember feeling like that was fucked up.
Yeah, he was great. His performance was great.
I think
in a leading role for Hacksaw Ridge.
Hacksaw Ridge, but only nominated.
Though, can we all just in unison say Brian is wrong on three? Ready? Yeah. One, two, three.
I looked it up myself.
Hold on. One, two, three.
I don't
Brian is wrong. Pull a fucking
bull. That's for bad jokes. That's not for being wrong.
Your whole entire existence is a bad joke. Pull a fucking, pull the whole thing.
Pull the bottom three. Pull the bottom three. Don't knock it over.
All right, here we go.
No.
Damn, you gotta pull something.
He just looked at his wrist and there's like, nothing there.
I ain't got no watch.
Looking pretty risky. Wow.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Risky.
Mm-hmm. Said risky because it's a wrist.
Yeah, it's a wrist.
Which, by the way, if you have sent in a Streamlab or a Super Chat, we'll get to that at the very end of the show.
Don't worry,
we're not ignoring. We appreciate any
That's always the case.
Donations. We very much appreciate that.
Can I tell you what, by the way? Can I tell you, people are so fucking excited for Wanger's Karaoke. Look at the viewership.
Look at that.
They saw it. People got what they needed, and they were like, "We're good, we got it."
Oh,
I'm telling you, I guarantee, people were in here waiting to find out if that was what it was and when it is, just to be sure.
And then
I think everybody knew that's what it was going to be.
Little jokes on them because we have the actual announcement.
Oh, here we go.
Let's hit them.
I should have done the. It'd be really funny if you saw a drop off after the shirt.
That was the announcement.
I mean, people did drop off after
some people, but that's. I mean, that's. Listen, we were baiting them with an announcement. Of course, that's going to happen. But I will say, it is. But it is, and it's late on the East Coast. On the East Side. But it is funny, but like, you know that people were like, it's got to be Carrie. It's got to be Carrie.
Got it. And I can go to bed. Yeah.
I have a feeling a lot of your listeners listen for the first hour or so and then finish with the podcast the next day. I wouldn't be surprised.
Probably.
Yeah. I do that sometimes myself.
By the way, we are on a video on Spotify.
On Spotify.
Oh, yeah, so if you ever just want to watch us on the go, not while you're driving, don't do that. Unless you're driving a Tesla.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I don't watch it, but I listen.
Yeah, there you go.
That's what I mean.
But it's also still on audio, Apple Podcasts, all that stuff. If you saw, there was a playback for a second because I got scared for a moment. They can't see this, but we can see the preview on YouTube. I thought that
was
our
cut off.
That's what I thought. I got scared.
But you zoomed up or you scrolled up.
Oh, I was about to ask
and
too.
Yeah.
Whoa, yeah. Weird.
We were scrolled down and then you can see me. I'm like, oh.
By the way, Kat's right. Kat said this video needs more likes. Everyone watching right now, if you haven't liked it, just click the like button.
Oh, yeah. There's 138.
I believe Kat found this channel because of last year's karaoke.
Eric.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised. I know Kat. Thank you, Kat. I know Kat. That's why I noticed. I absolutely know Kat.
Is she high all the time? She's always stoned.
Running joke.
I don't know.
Kat hates it. Kat hates it. We should really leave her alone.
Oh, but you guys, somebody said Kat falls asleep usually. Yeah, I mean, I feel like a lot of people probably on the East Coast, the show starts late.
Yeah. That's why we tried going a little bit earlier.
You went a little bit earlier, and it threw me for a loop.
Oh.
In a good way. But I was like, oh, here we go.
Well, you're at the bars on Monday nights. You're like,
damn right. On a Monday night. That was a Tuesday.
91 likes, baby. 91. Get it to.
Oh, is it going up? Is it live?
I don't want to. Everyone stop talking.
98. 98.
Everyone stop talking until I get to 100.
Give me 99.
101! What is this, college? What is this, a college class? Jesus.
Look at us go. Look at us go.
All right, now unlike it.
Yeah, everyone. No, everyone.
Would it go down, actually? Would it go down? I wonder if it would go down.
Don't dislike it. We can't take it.
Okay, I got an idea. I got.
What's your
okay.
idea?
Everyone watching live right now, when I say go, unlike it.
No!
But then, wait, hold on. Hold on. And then when I say... Okay, come back, then re-like
it. Just to see what happens?
Guys, yeah, I just want to see it.
We are playing with fire.
All right, go ahead. Here we go.
Our video's going to get... All right,
here we go.
Okay.
When I say go, everyone unlike it. All right, here we go.
Not dislike it, just unlike it.
Well, that doesn't exist anymore.
It does.
Really?
Or until it's...
But just like deselect the like button.
Okay, yes. And 3, 2, 1, go.
Unlike.
It's already gone down from when I saw it earlier.
Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. Now, like it again. Just like it. We're going to
keep it. That's it.
Like it again, please. I can't take it anymore. Oh, look. Yeah, it's going down.
I want to see it. No, hold on.
No. If it goes under 100, we kill ourselves.
I want to see.
I have cyanide pills.
I want to see like 20 drop at once. Ready?
No.
It's going to happen. Oh, Jesus Christ.
It went to 99.
Oh, my God. Is it going to go lower?
Look at this. Wait, go back up.
No. Come on. Come back up. Come back.
Come on. Don't go lower. Don't go. No.
Oh, it's a 91.
91. Jesus Christ. Hold on.
If we don't get back to 110, you fuck.
No, we're all right. It's back up to 99. It better be a... Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. 111.
We're good. We're good. Wow. We're at three triple digits.
I feel so powerful. Digits.
What a thrill. Am I peeking?
Everybody jump.
I think
everybody jump.
Everybody's
jumping up.
Everybody jump. Yeah. He's practicing for karaoke.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody jump.
Wow. We went from like 108 to like 97.
Not even 91. Now 112. Beautiful.
My heart stopped.
Thank you, guys.
That was awesome.
That was great.
You guys are so fucking great.
That was exciting.
Sheridan's like, this is a bad idea.
That was exciting. No, that was exciting. That was fun.
Thank you all. All right.
Oh, God. Okay.
So, yeah, you talked about click, click, boom.
Also, by the way, yeah, people just figured out how long the delay is we have.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. That's...
Yeah, thank you for doing that, though. 121.
121.
There you go. Nice. We're back.
There's 131 watching. Get us up to 130, baby.
Hell yeah. What did you say? Oh, I thought you meant... I thought you said get us up to 130 people watching, even though there's 136.
We'll take that. We'll take that, too. We'll take whoever's here.
Oh, what if we get more likes than people?
Well, that could happen because people left.
People left.
Just if you're in here now, here like and then leave.
Yeah. Create another account on three. Ready?
One, two, three.
Create another account, like the video. Okay, thank you.
Sign up for Google. Get two factor authorization.
Danny, summon
He's
yourself.
Asleep.
Shh, I'm summoning him.
Who?
Put the Streamlab. You know what I'm saying? Put the Streamlab in there. Take your wallet out. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
Enter your credit card information.
Is this what you fucking do?
Yes.
We just ask. We sit here and we ask for money for 2 hours straight. That's all we do.
First time. I told you guys about the stripper.
Which one?
Malibu. Oh,
no.
Didn't I talk about this on the last one? Speaking of asking for money for 2 hours.
You talked about a little person.
I told you that story.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did I tell you about when I someone tried to catfish me recently? Do we talk about that? Let me make sure that
we talked about it when we recorded the commentary.
I know, but I want to make sure that I don't tell the story again.
Yeah, please remind us.
Did I tell you how I can't say I got catfished because that implies that I got tricked. Mm-hmm. But did I tell the story on here of how someone tried to capture me? Does that sound familiar?
I don't think so. Say it.
All right. Well, maybe we'll come. Maybe I'll come around
give
to
the
that
deets.
Then.
Oh, not now.
I'm going to wait. Well,
that's your announcement.
That's my big announcement.
We have to wait
all
for
night I have announcements
segue.
To make. Oh.
Also, if you're watching on the playback, also hit that like button and leave a comment down
below.
Yeah,
please.
What? Unlike, then like.
Unlike it, then like it. And then leave a comment saying, what was your favorite moment from the first karaoke? Do that. That's fun.
And also, because if the dislike button is gone, just comment dislike.
That's good, too. Just dislike.
It gives engagement.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait. So was this stripper in Nashville? Or?
Well, the stripper story is unrelated, but that was her name was Malibu, quote unquote,
from LA.
Yeah, her name was quote unquote Malibu.
That's what her name tag said.
Okay. Quote unquote Malibu. Yeah.
Okay. Taco says no. I haven't heard it.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, but Julia knows about it. Hola, buenas tardes. Yeah, Julia knows. Cause
that's your business partner.
It happened live. The big finale of the story happened live in our Discord.
Oh.
But the stripper, Malibu,
Let's talk about this already.
Well, long story short with Malibu.
Malibu,
it's just funny because I was alone. Okay, here's another alone thing. You ever been alone at a strip club?
Absolutely not.
No.
Well, you're a married man.
Yeah, you're married, right?
You don't. Blink twice, Cody.
I've never been to a strip club.
And you missed your chance. That's it. It's over.
Can't go to a national strip club alone.
We can trick you into going. We can be like, we're inside, we're in the back.
Oh, it's like a clear alone.
And then he goes in. I went to a strip club out in LA. I was curious. I find it fascinating to like almost like compare and contrast strip clubs.
The one on the strip, cute club.
Yeah. I couldn't tell you the name. I couldn't tell you the name.
There's one by the Comedy Store that's like
it wasn't. It wasn't. I couldn't tell you the name. But I went and I misunderstood a
the
guy.
Assignment?
Well, no, I walked in. I paid my cover, and the guy said there's a 2-drink minimum, and I was like, well, yeah, whatever. That sounds fine. Whatever. Yeah.
This is in LA. You know, okay.
Yeah. But I went in like on a whim. I was like, oh man, this is, you know, this looks like a piece of shit place. I'm curious to see what it looks like.
It was in Hollywood?
Yeah, I don't remember where the hell it was, though. I don't remember where I was.
What day of the week is it? Because that...
Oh, it was...
It wasn't the weekend.
Probably not the weekend.
It was like the Beatles squad on like a Tuesday.
It was the Suicide Squad.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Of strippers.
I can't.
No. They were great. The strippers were not the problem. It was the venue. The strippers were all great. Okay, the strippers were great.
Yeah. You got to have a good venue. Like comedy club, musicians.
No, here's the problem. I went in, they said 2-drink minimum, and a gal comes over to me and she goes,
the delay.
It took way too long. He's reading things.
With
he's logging into GoDaddy or some
Chris
shit.
He's on the same timeline as the chat right now. He's the delay.
Yeah, he's actually, his headphones go to the stream. Wait, that would be funny.
He's one with the audio.
Wait a minute. That would be fucking hilarious.
Try to interact
Christian,
with
can you take this out and put it into the stream? So you're delayed and you can't hear us?
So disoriented.
Next time. Can we do that? Can we try to prepare for that next time? That's fucking hilarious.
That was like 30 seconds later.
He's like, great joke, guys.
Next time we have somebody out of the room listening to the stream and trying to, and literally responding to us like it's live. That's fucking brilliant. We're going to do it next time. Be back on the 20th for that.
So mean.
But so
mean.
What's the mean part?
Yeah,
making fun of you?
Yeah. No. I don't care about that. Never.
Did I say something mean? Did I miss it?
No, you're just
so
talk.
No. So what happened was the
Suicide Squad.
That wasn't it. Listen, the strippers were great. I was joking. Yeah. The strippers were great.
It's
They're
the
fine.
Venue. It's the venue.
Here's the problem. Yes. Ready?
Amanda Waller.
I go in. And I go...
The acoustics?
No. The acoustics are fine. The acoustics are fine. The acoustics were fine as well. Do I actually...
No, that's a good one.
Okay.
That's a good one.
No, they were great. They were fine. They were great. The problem was I get 2-drink minimum. A girl comes over to me and she goes, "What do you want to drink?" And I was like, "What do you have? On, you know, you have anything on tap?
On tap?
You know,
on tap only."
Well, do you have anything
Nashville?
On tap, or is it just bottles and cans? You know, whatever. And
bottles
she goes, "No,
cans.
We don't." And I was like, "All right, well, what do you have like beer wise?" And she goes, "We don't have any alcohol."
So you have to buy sodas?
She said, "We have soda and Red Bull."
That's the 2-drink minimum? Soda?
I asked for 2 waters.
That'll also be $12 each.
That you had to pay for?
Oh, yeah. No, I said, I don't care how much they cost. I'll take 2 water bottles, please. I don't want... I'm not going to sit here with a Red Bull. Okay? I'm not going to sit
Red
here
Bulls, please.
And watch a stripper while drinking a Red Bull.
Like, whoa, let's go.
Let's go. Yeah, like, that's terrifying. That's like...
I've never heard of a
Jeffrey
two-drink.
Dahmer behavior.
Diet Red Bull.
Diet Red Bull on the rocks. Yeah, no, I've never heard of a
non-alcoholic
in there too.
2-drink minimum.
Me neither. Oh, no. I mean, I feel like if you have like a comedian that's doing like an all-ages show or a band doing an all-ages show, I feel like you'd get a 2-drink minimum. But a strip club with a 2-drink minimum with no alcohol is fucking
that's
deranged.
Weird,
that's psychotic.
Well, the LA law is again going with like full nudity and alcohol.
I think that's part of what it was. Mm. Yeah.
Do they go full nude?
I don't remember. That's the thing. I don't remember Grey Bush. I don't remember. It didn't stick out in my mind quite enough.
Okay.
I don't remember. I just remember sitting there and being like, "Eric, you deserve this." Because I was like, this place looks less than stellar, and I'm curious.
Oh.
So that's why I went in. And then I literally was
girls,
like,
"Girls, girls, girls on the."
I was like, "Yeah, this is what I what you you got what you deserve." Yeah,
this was here in LA. This was here in LA.
LA area?
Okay. Yes, but the Malibu one was in...
Oh, yeah.
I want to say Malibu was in, like...
Malibu.
Utah. Yeah, she was a Mormon. she had a sheet up. Or is that... That's a Jewish joke, isn't it?
I don't know.
A Mormon joke. I don't remember.
I can't help you here.
You
know the Jews, Cody?
Come on, you know the jokes? That's an inoffensive joke, by the way. That's not offensive. But no, I think... I want to say it was in, like, Philly.
Malibu's in Philly?
Malibu, Pennsylvania.
I'm Malibu. I'm but from
was, it was really funny. It was really funny. It is kind of funny if like a stripper introduced herself and it's gonna be like, oh, that's a beautiful name, dude. You know, yeah. Because like it's not their name.
I'm Malibu. I'm from Philly.
I'm Malibu tonight, sweetheart. But no, the funny thing about that
I'm
one
Malibu
was
to leave.
I was. Oh, jeez.
Yeah,
That warrants a fuck
you up.
No,
like,
no.
I liked it. I don't care.
I veto it.
Okay.
You psychopath. Why would you put it on the bar? You pulled it out from, you lunatic.
No, it's even.
No, it's not.
He took it out from this side.
He's got two on the right there.
Oh, so this is going to take
that. You like that?
Yeah, psycho. Anyway. Long story short, Malibu, the funny thing about her was I went into this strip club, and I go in alone. I find it fascinating. I just want to like sort of, I'll be honest, like, you know, get
how
like comfortable
works.
With the scene. Exactly.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Just in general, I'm like, you know, this is like could potentially be an awkward situation depending on who you are or whatever. But like you go in alone or you go in with friends, whatever. And it's fun, whatever. I don't know if anyone agrees that it's fun. I think it's fun. But so I went in and my thought was, I think I'm curious to see what happens in the champagne room.
Okay. Oh, you never been in the back.
Did I not talk about this before?
No.
On here?
I don't think so.
Are you sure?
You talked about the little person one.
Stop me if I... Yeah, well, yeah, that was a separate issue.
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Stop me if I've told this before. I'm going to
keep
little
person
chat.
Wasn't the issue. That was...
No, that was the point. Exactly. The little person was not the issue. Yeah. But so... But I was like, you know what? I'm curious to see what goes on behind closed doors. Like, what is this? You always hear about it. You always hear about the champagne room, whatever,
Chris
the back
Rock
room.
Has a song, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
But so I was like, I'm curious. And you got to, like, you could always wonder or you could find out.
Or you can do.
So I was like, let me find out.
You could be a doer, yeah.
And so, huh?
You
I hardly know her. But so I,
Malibu?
So point is,
Malibu to Lee.
Point is, are you disconnected?
No, I'm just talking
I heard Malibu so far in the distance just now.
That's his confidence in the joke.
Malibu. 30 Malibu. Seconds later again. That's a good joke.
Bitch.
Somebody said I recall the champagne room, but okay, whatever. So long story short, though, because I don't, maybe I've told it already. It's not even about the champagne room, barely, but it's just about Malibu, my sweetheart.
Yes, from Philly.
From Philly. I went, so I was like, all right, well, I'll wait because, you know, whatever, especially if you're sitting alone, but I guess regardless, girls come up to you, they go dance, they come up to you and they'll be like, hey, do you want to go somewhere private?
Private,
you know, blah,
dance,
blah. And it's
yeah.
like, you know, it's a transactional thing.
Even
they're
the
DJ's
like, come on, for dances.
Party one.
Please go over to that guy sitting alone.
Party one, dances, $200. $200.
This place was fucking horrible because the stage was behind the bar. So you couldn't even sit at the stage. And there was a guy sitting across from me at the bar eating wings.
They had food at this
one. Yeah. I was like, this is a fucking nightmare. This is horrible.
My God, this sounds like the middle of
horrible.
Nowhere.
But that's what I love to see. Like weird. I want, give
weird
me the weirdest
shit.
Place
oh,
you can
love,
give me.
I love it.
I love it.
Okay.
But so, what happened was.
What happened? Did they approach you? Did they like ask you for a dance?
Whatever. Over a little while, girls are asking, you know, coming up, whatever. You want to dance? You know, blah, blah, blah. And so there's, you want to dance? That's one dance, whatever. Or do you want to go to the other
in
room
the back,
kind of
yeah,
deal?
VIP, yeah.
So I think, but the way it would go is that you would get a dance and then they would ask if you, like, hey, the song's over, but would you like to go to the other room? You know, like that's how it goes.
Oh, they double down.
So, Did she smoke a 12-pack of cigarettes?
Yes.
Song's over. Song's over.
So I did the one dance, whatever. Great, fine. Yeah, sure.
Was it Harvey Fierstein?
It was. I wish. But I, so then I was like, I literally, if you could see me, I literally went, you know what? I do. I do want to go to the champagne room, actually.
Is this your catfish story, too?
No, it's not. Jesus, this is unrelated.
Christ.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
Okay. No, don't sorry. Don't be sorry. Just do the right thing.
Okay, but so what happened was I went to the champagne room.
She went to the back,
Went to the back, and it was great. It was fine. You know, it was pretty
what
much what you'd expect. I would never do it again. It's just you get the same dances out there, but for 30 minutes instead of...
Half hour.
Well, yeah, it was like a half hour back there, but it's like... Nothing. I was curious. I was like, what is she going to do? Like, what is going to happen
back
here? She sucked
you off, yeah.
So I was curious to see what she was going to try to do. I was like, what is going to happen back here? Obviously, that's not legal, I'm pretty sure. So I was like, I don't think this is going to happen.
I don't think that's legal. By the way, I'm a cop.
But my point is, I was like, what is this? Like, is this, like, shady? Like, what is going to happen back here? I was very curious. Okay. And so, but the thing is, literally just the same thing for 30 minutes. And
it's
like,
the same
thing. You get a bottle. You get, like, bottle service, whatever.
You do get.
So, yeah.
You don't get another Red Bull.
No, this was a different place.
Oh, okay.
This is Philly.
You're Philly, yeah.
But the funniest part, She goes, we were chatting. My problem is I'm bad with this stuff because I just want to chat.
She's like talk sexy to dancing on you. It's like, oh my God, so what are you doing? Like, what are you doing?
Literally, what's your real name? Yeah. You think it's funny, but yeah. Hey, the only reason I came to the champagne room is to find out your real fucking name. You say that as a joke, Christian, but that literally is my problem.
Oh my God, like, have you seen Lamb recently? Oh my God, it's so good.
That to me is worth the price of admission. That's way more interesting to get stories out of them.
Yo,
so I was like, this is great. I want to hear some stories.
I want to hear stories.
Yes.
Do you like M. Night Shyamalan's The Village?
Yes.
What would you do?
I point to my shirt. Because I also have that shirt, by the way.
If her bikini said M. Night
Shyamalan. I would love that.
Ooh. And then the bottom part said Village.
Single rider.
Single rider. Hey, that actually makes sense.
Yes.
But I should wear that shirt into a strip club. Single rider.
Single rider line.
But is there a single rider line? But so, anyway, long story short, she goes.
Party of three.
She said she visited somewhere. I'm not trying to hide where it was. I don't remember where she said she visited. She was like, oh, so we were talking about traveling. She was like, you like to travel? I was like, yeah, I love to travel. And she was like, I love to travel. I was like, where was the last place you've been? Again, I have to know, you know. And I was like, where's the last place you've been? And she said something like, yeah, you know, oh, I was in wherever. And I was like, oh, that sounds great. How long did you go for? What'd you do? Whatever. You know?
As she's on you.
Yeah, just literally. Like
her vagina's in your face.
Quite literally. Yeah. And she goes, she's like, oh, yeah, we went there. We were supposed to go for a week, but we left after a day. And I was like, oh, okay.
What happened? Yeah. There's more to the story.
Let's go, Malibu. Let's go. So I was like, why? What happened? She goes,
I want to hear the story. I got to pee so bad.
She goes, so literally she turns around. She was like facing me. She turns around and starts like dancing on me from whatever with her behind.
Yeah.
And she goes, oh, we found out they eat dogs.
Oh. Don't
she
say.
Goes, they
Don't
eat dogs. Say. And so we left. Like while she's dancing, she's whispering this in my ear. And I was like, all right.
She goes,
okay.
She's like, woof.
And I don't remember, again, I genuinely don't remember where she said it was, whatever. So that's irrelevant. Yeah. But she said that. And again, she is dancing.
She's fully nude.
Not fully nude, but even. Well, it was when we first got in there.
Oh, it was the beginning.
Right at the beginning. But so she's dancing and she's saying this. And I was like, but again, to be honest with you, I was like, this is what I'm here for.
This is perfect.
I want to have a stripper tell me about how she left her vacation early because they found out about the delicacy, the local delicacy.
When did it come out? Did they find out like it was served to them?
But, first of all, how do you not know where you're going? Second of all, you left.
How do you not do research and see like what happens here?
It was incredible. Yeah. It was incredible. And I would do that again. It was fucking brilliant. It was so fucking
Philly.
Great.
Check out Malibu in Philly.
There you go. Malibu, Pennsylvania. Oh my God. Twitter, I almost just drank this way.
Oh, you would have gotten there eventually.
Okay, yeah, you're
I kind of want you to go to strip clubs when like major world events are happening, like the election or something like that. It's like, who'd you vote for?
But so that's exactly what I would do. That's what I'm talking about.
Like, well, something crazy is going on.
For me, it's like, sure, dance, but like, I want to hear more. I want to hear what you're talking about.
Get their hot take on stuff.
Yeah, exactly. I want the hot takes. It was fascinating. It was fascinating. Somebody asked, where is this place in Philly? I don't remember the name. Oh, you want to avoid it? Sorry, I can't help you. I don't remember the name.
Okay,
I've never been to a strip club.
You never been to one?
Never been to one.
Never have.
Cody, should we go together and just be awkward? Just be very
Wanger's drive through strip club.
A drive through strip club is a fascinating idea.
I think they did that in Vegas last year during the quarantine.
Oh, that's fascinating.
I think they did.
Was it just like the red light district where they're behind glass?
Did they get on top of the car?
I've been there.
You've been there?
I've been there in Amsterdam.
Oh,
absolutely.
They do some freaky stuff over there.
Yeah, I didn't go in, but I saw the windows. Literally, it's there. It's a whole thing.
That's pretty cool. Nice.
Man, I'm trying to picture how that would work.
You and me in a strip club together.
not just that. That as well. But like, do they get up on top of the car?
I hope so. They dent the car.
Yeah.
Like the car alarm goes off.
Is there like a sunroof situation? Mm. What's going on here? I don't know. I don't know the legit.
They're reaching in and rubbing your head.
Exactly.
Oh, you know what's really fun? You know, okay, so the thing is like, I understand why people go to strip clubs in general, but the reason I go is... Like, okay.
For the experience.
It's partially because, like, yes, there's beautiful women dancing. Great fun. Yeah, that's the idea. But also for the awkward things that happen along the way. Like, like we just talked about.
Great stories.
And I sat down at a different strip club. This one was in Kentucky. Again, you gotta go to the ones in, like, Kentucky and Philly.
The middle of America.
Yes. Yeah. But I sat down at one and fuck, I'll never forget, but it was like brilliant. It happened, and I literally was like, yes, what a dream come true. sitting there at the stage. It was not like the other one where you couldn't even sit at the stage or whatever, because that seems like a huge part of the strip club that was missing at the Philly one, but okay. So I'm sitting at the stage. This girl's dancing. She's beautiful. She's great. She's having fun. You know, she's whatever. And I hope she's having fun. By the way, any strippers that I've spoken to at that strip club that night, I literally asked this girl for a dance. Like, hey, do you do private dances? Okay, great. Yeah. And she was like, I'll come find you. She came and sat down with me. We talked for an hour about musical theater and we never got a dance.
Have you seen Tick Boom with Andrew Garfield?
Yes. But no, literally she sat down. So I'm just saying, like, I went in with that intention, but like, I can't help but be myself. Hey. And myself, she sat down. She's like, so what's your deal? And I was like, you want to talk about Broadway? I don't know how it came up. I think I asked, like, what's your deal? And she was like, I used to dance when I was younger. And I was like, oh, yeah. And she's like, yeah, I love Broadway. And I was like, what musicals have you seen? And I never got the dance. The place closed and she walked away.
Where was this at? Was this in New York?
This was in
Broadway?
Kentucky. Kentucky.
But Kentucky.
Point is, I sat down with the fucking guy, the same girl that I asked after she did her performance on the stage there, whatever. The reason I said that is because she was enjoying it. She loved it. She was like, this is something that I've always wanted to do. And I was like, all right, great. That sounds great. But so a guy next to me thinks he's fucking James Bond. He has a wad of bills and he goes, because, you know, that's like cool, right?
Like throw, like
toss them on the stage.
Ones,
they all hit me. He goes like this, but like, let's go too late. And they go.
So you got naked. And
well, so I picked him up and just put him on the stage. I started dancing. Oh, that would be fucking hilarious.
Yes.
That would make
hits.
The stripper would probably be laughing too hard to finish her dance if I did that. Are you kidding me?
Get on stage, get fully nude.
I'm going to fucking do that. But that, I think I would get punched in the face. I'm pretty sure I'd get punched in the face.
Well, you should have punched the guy that threw bills on you.
Hey, thanks, man. I should have pocketed that.
Yeah.
No, but I put them on stage, but it was so fucking awkward because I love when people think they're in their own little James Bond movie. And it just doesn't happen like you think it's going to happen. Yeah. No, you're in reality. And it goes right on me.
That's not how the dollar bills work.
No, that's not how dollar bills go.
They'll like feather out.
It goes all over your food that you have too. God damn it.
Your wings.
These are my wings. The sad wings guys.
Oh, that was at the Philly one. My God.
This was in Kentucky. You were talking about
what? Wanger's drive through strip club edition.
Oh, that's what we were just talking about.
It's just going to be us driving to the strip club and it's going to be a hard cut. All of us wide eyed just...
Didn't they do during the pandemic?
That's
they
what
did.
We just talked
oh
about
fuck!
That.
I was gone.
You're out.
Damn it!
How long were you being?
Yeah, that was a big pee.
Yeah,
that
was a
big
fucking
pee.
Suicide Squad.
You like that? You like that one?
Sorry.
Oh boy!
What are you guys up to? What's going on?
I don't know,
man. I don't even know what I did this weekend.
Chilling,
smoking.
Average watch time 9:11.
Where do you see that? Oh, there it is.
Oh, that's appropriate.
They can't see that.
Yeah.
I know. So but
it's timestamps on your video. And when
I'm just letting them know.
As soon as you click, it's on the thumbnail.
No, 9:13.
Conspiracy.
Okay, all right.
We're back. Yeah.
Also, 139 likes, but 142 viewers. Can we get three more? We want to have more. We want to have more likes than viewers. That'd be awesome.
Hit that motherfucking like button, bitch.
Oh, I was giving you music to dance to.
Oh, okay, go again.
Give him a sound bed.
That's what Malibu dances to.
All too well.
Coming to the stage, this is Christian Rivacaba.
The littlest dancer you've ever seen.
Some people call him Copster, but only if you want.
Hey, what the fuck is this little thing?
He's still in my phone as Copster. Is that all right?
Is he?
Oh, that's fine. He doesn't like it.
Most people change it. Well, I have him in there as Nick. You know, you can put a nickname.
Yeah.
He's in there with his nickname as Copster.
What's the full name?
Christian.
All right.
Say my last
name. Christian Copster.
Something? I don't know what I was going with that.
Yeah, right. That's what I'm talking about.
Most people Ruby. Who don't take me serious call me Copster still. Oh. They just see me as an object.
More likes than viewers. Woo!
Yeah, people left.
Yeah, people.
We did.
Yeah, I guess we could say that at any point.
Yeah, people just left.
We can say that for the rest of the night. Sorry, everybody. Nobody liked my... You know, it is confusing to tell like a strip club story because it's like, on one hand, it's like, ugh, men. But on the other hand, it's like sex workers.
Oh,
so it's
like what are you?
Yeah, right. Like, pick a side.
Are you supporting that?
Yeah, right. Pick a side. Are you against going or are you for going? You know.
Well, we talked about this kind of with last night in Soho, but I don't know if we want to get into.
Have we all seen it?
Cody has
not. Oh, okay, we can't talk about too much. Yeah. Oh, we talked about this yesterday a little bit. Yeah. We won't. Let's not be. That's a big spoiler.
Because I saw it this past weekend, and then we talked about it in person. So there's no point of talking about it now.
Yeah, once we talk about it in person, we can't.
It's hard to talk. Not
it's a spoiler.
Yeah,
yeah.
But I think you know.
I can
careful.
Take a very long piss right now.
You can take a big pee.
No, that's fine.
Yeah.
All
right.
No, but it.
No, you don't get to
it's
leave.
It's a testament to the.
I will piss my pants if you guys don't talk about that.
Use these bottles.
It is a testament to the movie that we had such a good conversation. About
I agree.
It,
I'd rather talk about a movie.
Yeah,
that's what I mentioned. I mentioned to you, Laura and I spoke a lot more about Last Night in Soho
than any other than like Shang-Chi or something.
Than Dune.
Oh, yeah, sure,
Shang-Chi.
That's fair.
Oh,
yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, it was great. It was very fun.
I had a great time.
I think it devolved into the typical Marvel shit at the end, but otherwise,
yeah, like crazy insane shit.
Well, the dragon was cool, but I can't stand like a field with animals. I'm so sick of it. A field with a war and animals. Like, how many times have we seen this?
Black Panther.
Black Panther. Infinity War, etc., etc. I think that happened in so many of them.
There's like creatures.
There was a field at least, and it was Wakanda again, if I remember correctly.
Forever, yeah.
Which isn't that the name of the new movie? Wakanda again.
Wakanda forever
again.
No, it's Wakanda story.
Dot again. Yeah. Black Panther with a question mark.
I put on Shang-Chi because it's on Disney Plus now, right? Mm-hmm. That's how you're... And they had, like, the IMAX version, so I was like, oh, yeah.
I'll watch that way.
I was like, I'll watch it like this, and then
IMAX?
Yeah, it was like IMAX version. It's just full screen.
Wow. It just shows the full frame of the IMAX.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And I watched it, and I was like,
It's a movie?
I saw Scott Derrickson.
But you had already seen it.
I'd already seen it.
You watched it again, Shang-Chi.
Yeah.
Okay.
I fell asleep. I like the
In
first...
the theater?
No, like, at home.
Have you ever fallen quickly swallowed his drink for that. Hold on.
Yeah, Jesus.
Have you guys ever fallen asleep in a theater?
In Eternals.
Oh, you almost fell asleep.
Yes, I've fallen asleep in a theater.
I think that was the first time I've ever been truly like tired Eternals? During a Marvel movie. Yeah, I was tired.
During Eternals, you almost fell asleep?
I almost fell asleep so much as I was like, oh, jeez. Like,
but it's hilarious.
I didn't need to sleep, but I was definitely like,
I could pass.
Oh, you were checking your watch.
Not even. I'm doing a really? You're going so fucking literal.
Well, you do that.
I know. I mean, I'm sure I looked at my watch, but I'm just saying it was the first time in as long as I can remember, I wasn't like engrossed by what's going on. And I was like, all right, how much is left?
It was just funny. Like, oh, another sunset shot. Another shot where they're
golden
sunset
hour.
Or soul. Yeah. Yeah. Like, just,
we get it, Chloe. We get it.
I will say
nature.
You shot outside.
We got it.
The first like maybe 45 minutes of Dune, and I was like, come on. Like,
but then it picked up.
It picked up.
Oh,
it picks up pretty quickly.
Yeah.
And like the action is like classy. I think we talked about this last time, but it's not classy.
Which one? Eternals or Dune?
Dune. Like, like the action.
We're not talking about Shang-Chi.
No. Wait, also, have you seen Dune or Eternals?
No.
Okay, so I was going to say, we just want to spoil anything.
Mike, can I just get a soundbite of Cody saying no?
No.
Thank you.
Remember when we did that? We could do that. We could do a live version of the bit where I try to guess if it's in the room or not. You remember when we did that on a stream? I was trying to guess if it was a soundbite or
soundbite or real person.
Yes.
I still want to do the bit where we call somebody and only talk to them through soundbite.
We got to plan it out.
Prank call.
Yeah.
But like real.
Absolutely.
I have Cody saying, yeah, no.
Put together a whole conversation.
Yeah.
I love that.
All right. You want to go down on me?
But yeah.
I don't think we have that sound.
No. Don't include that one. That's illegal.
You like the Shang-Chi?
I did.
Yeah.
I did. I thought it was a long movie, but I thought it was very well paced. I was like, this is kind of flying by.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the ending, while Eric is correct about the tropes about fighting in a field and shit, I thought like this was batshit crazy. They're fighting on dragons.
The dragon was a cool addition, but then on the ground we keep cutting to the same old ship. But yeah, the dragon was cool.
I had a great time with Shang-Chi.
Have you not seen it?
I haven't seen it.
Oh, well, there's a dragon.
I like the first half. I like when they actually focused on the action because that was like the big selling point.
Like
it was
the hand-to-hand fights and shit like that?
Like the bus scene is fucking awesome.
Yeah.
It was so fucking cool.
Jaw on the floor. I couldn't believe it. I was in the theater and I was like, I had seen like snippets of the trailer just because, you know, you're walking around, you see little snippets and I'm like, oh, there's a bus fight. Yeah, sure, whatever.
Mm.
But I remember thinking like, oh, this bus scene is going to be so typical, like whatever, you know?
No, it was
and
like...
And I was shocked. Yeah, I was shocked. Like, it was
like,
fucking awesome.
It was like a one take on the outside. Like, yeah, there's VFX in it.
Cody likes the wonders.
But it's like a one take on the
outside
of the bus.
Like, that, yeah.
Like it's like fucking really well done. Yeah. And then it just goes into the Marvel stuff.
Yeah.
But it has to.
Yeah.
Like it has to like.
Does it? Did Eternals didn't.
Did it work?
No. No, you know, I will. I appreciate that. Actually, no. The best part of Eternals was like the no spoilers, but like the you can imagine this a final fight, whatever. You know, no. The best part is the final fight, quote unquote. But like, it's not the typical thing. Like, it was a little more interesting.
A little more interesting, philosophical.
It's like you.
No. There was a
I'm
fight.
Talking to you.
There's a fight, but like, you know, yeah. I guess there's a little bit of that, but there is a fight, and it was
it's
more
a subversion
interesting.
Of it.
Okay. That was more interesting than
yeah.
The last act of Eternals I might have enjoyed more than like the last act of Shang-Chi, actually. But the thing is, the rest of it I preferred. So
you want the first half of Shang-Chi and the second half of Eternals all in one movie?
It's hard to say.
You know, we were talking about Spider-Man Far From Home or No Way Home, whichever the title
No Way
is.
Out.
No Way Home.
No Way Home. Like, I see, like, on Instagram, like, the runtime, like, it's like 2 hours and 40-something minutes or something like that.
For
like,
a Spider-Man movie?
Dude.
Long. Yeah, well, that's going to need to be long as shit.
Because
they got to cram it.
There's
a lot
of stuff in that movie, too, so.
Well, I've been wanting to go to the theaters, but, like, the only thing out is, like, No Time to Die, and that's, like, 2:45.
I still haven't seen it.
It's pretty good. I enjoyed it. Yeah.
Do I need to see Spectre?
It's kind of like a
jeez, man, I'm behind on James Bond.
Like a Daniel. I'm sure there's like fucking YouTube videos. Where like,
I know, but I would watch the movie if I have to. I would watch
Spectre.
The movie.
Spectre is not like I'm not a huge James Bond fan. Like technically, like it's a Sam Mendes movie, so like you're gonna get some like
he did Spectre too.
Yeah, he did Spectre and Skyfall.
Oh, I didn't know he did Spectre.
Sam Mendes.
Yeah. I thought he just did Skyfall.
No, yeah,
Skyfall, Spectre, and this one, as far as I know,
he did. No
wait, did he do the
die?
No? He, no, sorry, Carrie Fukunaga did the new one. My bad. Yeah, my bad.
But like, there's some like the opening scene for Spectre is like all in one take, and it's like
that's cool,
like, classfully done stuff. Yeah. It's just like story wise, I don't care
Maybe I'll squeeze it in this week. Maybe I'll watch it this week, and then I'll go and see the new. No way, no
it's
time
on like demand now, right?
Yeah, I think
you can rent it.
Yeah, you can rent it.
Oh no,
is No Time to Die available at home now?
I think it is now.
Oh jeez, well I should see it in theaters though, right?
Yeah,
yeah. It's
by the way, we picked up on viewers when I started talking about strippers.
You see that?
Yeah.
You see that?
It should label
how'd
like
they know?
Comments or topics, strippers.
Oh, I got to see.
200 views.
How'd they know?
Let me look at my letterbox. I have been watching.
Wait. Cody left so we can spoil stuff.
Oh, about
okay,
what?
All right.
I don't know.
Careful. Last night he can probably hear, though, so be quiet, though.
Oh, yeah.
He can probably hear.
You want to do Last Night in Soho?
Yeah, let's talk. But sure. Talk quiet. Whisper. Sure. Whisper. Yeah, we were talking about it. Like
Last Night in Soho.
She was
spoilers for Last Night in Soho.
Yeah,
spoilers.
Yeah. For real. Mute until Cody comes back in. Honestly.
Yeah, for spoilers. Last Night in Soho.
We were talking about how like the end message was muddled because it was like she's killing all these guys, but also like she's kind of a sex worker.
Like that's the job.
Yeah, that's the job. And they're coming in like under the guise of like this is a professional transaction.
Not be like you, like a stripper killing you.
Yeah. If a stripper killed me, like you sick fucking man. Yeah. It's like, well, what the fuck? It's a strip club. Don't kill me, please.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
the guys are creepy. The guys are fucking
creepy. The guys are fucking creepy. No, for sure. Yeah, they're 100%. Yes, they are creepy. But you're also victimizing someone who's doing horrible acts. Like, even though there's consent, technically,
but it's a transaction.
They didn't approach her. Yeah. She wasn't like walking home and they came up to her and started like humping her. Like, she like invited them in.
Took their money.
For money. I appreciated that the ghosts were like, save us. And she's like, no, fuck you. But even though they were technically the victims.
Yeah,
they're victims. But she's also a victim.
But maybe she was so traumatized from the initial guy.
But then kill Jack. Just Jack.
Just
kill the fucking guy. Only kill Jack.
Kill the fucking guy. It's not the 100
people. She didn't want to get into that line of work.
Okay.
But Jack kind of forced her into it in a way. So there's a power play to it.
But so she hated Jack so much, she had to kill 100 guys.
The guys don't know that when they show up. Like that's about, yeah, like if I go to McDonald's and the drive-thru person doesn't want to be there, it's like, I don't know that. Don't fucking kill me. Please don't fucking, just give me honey mustard with my fries, please. What the fuck? I don't know that you want to be here.
Don't take it out on me.
Yeah. Also, I know we're in a library and you're a librarian. I didn't know you don't want to be here. Please don't fucking kill me.
Yeah. Don't take it out on me. Like,
please don't fucking kill me.
Like you said, well, the strip club transaction, if you go to the champagne room, you expect to dance.
Exactly.
You don't expect to be murdered.
Imagine if she was like, the champagne room actually is degrading and I'm going to fucking kill you. It's like, well, then why did you ask me if I want to go to this fucking champagne room? Okay, but this is as men talking about a situation about a woman, and there is a power play to it.
Sure, for the woman, the woman wants to take the power back.
But just kill Jack.
But no, she's so traumatized. She wants to take power.
We're mansplaining.
She wants to take away all men.
Well, it's not mansplaining if you're telling someone not to murder people. I will gladly mansplain to tell you not to murder someone. I'll do that. I'll take one for the team.
No, I think even with murder, you can't mansplain.
Can't mansplain. My only problem was, but like, we're joking around, but for real, those guys didn't know that, like, she was going to, like, they thought it was a transactional thing. And I think the way that they portray the men, they come off as, like very, very creepy, but it was still a consensual kind of thing. Yes, they're creepy, but, like, she doesn't have to kill them. I don't think being creepy makes you should be murdered.
But what? Okay,
because then none of us would have uncles.
Oh, the creepy.
Okay, this is kind of long enough.
Okay, how's your voice doing?
It's okay. I can keep going.
Any more spoilers for Eternals or Shang-Chi?
You haven't seen them.
I don't care. I'm not going to see Eternals.
No, but last night, so Kumail Nanjiani literally says, I'm sitting out the final battle. And oh, it's actually kind of badass if you think about it. He literally goes, I actually agree with the villain, and I'm not going to fight.
Whoa.
And he just disappears for the rest of the
movie. He's like, I'm taking Thanos aside.
Yes. Yeah, kind of.
He literally, and I respect the shit out of that. I do. I appreciate
that. So it's a philosophical message of like, I kind of agree with his message.
Also, we should be careful because we didn't necessarily say eternal spoilers. Oh, yeah, yeah. Sorry, it's fine. It's, fine. It's not a huge spoiler.
No,
sorry.
No, it's fine. It's fine. But so I enjoyed last night in Soho until the horror movie kind of got in the way.
Yeah, I agree. Like,
Yo, like, everything else is
good. Oh, shut up, shut up. Wait, wait.
Come in.
Anyway, so titties.
Yeah. So much ass.
Talking about strip clubs again.
Sex.
Yeah, it's got a married man. We don't want to talk about that.
What did you want me to clean in here or anything? What did you want to clean?
What? Did you text him and say, do you want me to clean here? No, are you good?
He was gone for a while.
Are you okay? Oh, you were asking if you needed more time.
Guys, I was.
Or did you take
there.
A fat dump?
How's the bathroom?
I did not poo. The bathroom's beautiful.
Isn't it? Now it
it's
is.
Nuts. Sorry. But I walked in there and, like, I get the text from Christian guys talking spoilers. I'm like, okay.
We're good now. We're good now.
We're good. Yeah.
Then I'm like, okay, I'll just hang out. And I'm just sitting there in the bathroom. I'm like, do you want me to clean or anything in here? Do you want me to pass the time? Right. I want to, like, clean your bathroom for you.
Did you use the smaller hand towel that's on the counter?
Okay. Of course I did. I use that every time.
What headphone volume are you? 3?
Yeah.
What if we turn you down and we whisper like this? Can you hear us, Cody?
Can you hear us right now?
I mean, like, if I want to really.
Yeah, he can.
Can you play music in his headphones?
Yeah, just in his chest.
Yeah.
He answered us so cleanly. He's like, yeah, I can hear
you. Yeah, I can absolutely hear you. Yeah, well, he answered us, so that really sort of says it, doesn't it?
We did a whole spoiler review in whisper tone.
Yeah. Oh, appreciate that. I was looking at my Letterboxd, see what I watched. I watched The Guilty. The Jake Gyllenhaal movie.
I watched that.
The news. Let's talk about that.
It was pretty.
He's not in the news, really.
He's
is
in
he?
The news.
He's in the news if you're fucking 14.
What happened?
Oh. Well, please explain that.
I don't know.
It's a good movie.
All I know is he dated Taylor Swift almost over a decade ago for 3 months and apparently like stole her scarf or some shit. And, she's still fucking talking
is
about it.
Is that what the 10-minute song on SNL was about?
Yes.
Yeah,
it was about Jake Gyllenhaal.
Now, hold on. That song was written 10 years ago.
Right, that's true. That's true.
It's not like she's like still writing songs about it.
No, that would be fucking
weird. Why does she still perform it then?
Because she got the rights to her music back, so she re-released the album.
And it's also not her fault. Version. Her fans are perpetuating it. She's not talking about that.
But she made like a whole video.
Yeah.
She like directed.
Yeah, she made an entire short film actually about it. And the guy is supposed to be Jake Gyllenhaal. If you think about it,
it's not her fault.
It's
not her fault. It's clearly a guy that with a beard and a beanie. Looks like Jake Gyllenhaal.
Still an O'Brien, right?
Yes. He's in the still O'Brien. Sadie something
with
or other.
Like Sadie Sink. Isn't she like
she's 19?
Like
that's the whole point.
She's 12. I think they were doing. I think that was the idea. Yes, because I didn't watch. Did you watch it?
Yes, they showed it in the background on SNL.
Yeah.
But yeah.
For 10 minutes.
Oh, I didn't see it on SNL.
For
10
minutes, they showed the whole thing.
Yeah.
Is that copyright? Yeah. How does that work?
It's her own shit.
She copyright claims SNL.
SNL. No, but yeah, we looked it up. Laura was like, how old is this girl? Because it's like an old-ass dude with like a beard.
She was just in Stranger Things. It's like a little
teen
bopper.
Taylor Swift was young when she dated Jake Gyllenhaal.
Well, then that's her fault.
Hey, whoa!
Cody, is that what you're saying?
I mean,
no.
To be clear, we should be clear. We don't know what this is.
I don't
know.
I have no idea.
This is my understanding of why Jake Gyllenhaal was trending this week.
Oh.
I don't know about this. I don't care about this.
Yeah.
But to answer the question, this is my understanding of why he's been trending this week.
I didn't know he was trending.
I was like, let's look at the chat. All caps everywhere. Guys, I'm trying.
Holy
I'm
shit,
to
people are bugging.
What's the age difference?
It's the age difference between Dylan O'Brien and Sadie Sink is similar to what Taylor Swift
it's,
and Jake Gyllenhaal were when they
like
dated.
30,
no,
yeah,
not 12. Jake Gyllenhaal's not in his 40s, is he?
Well, he's got to be in his 40s.
Dylan
O'Brien
is like 30, and Sadie Sink is 19.
Jake Gyllenhaal's
got
to be in his 40s.
This was 10 years ago when their relationship was, guys.
Yeah, but
it's not that hard.
But that's also not the problem. That's not an issue.
Oh, it's a hit piece because he came out with The Guilty. They're trying to cancel him.
They're trying to cancel his ass.
Fucking cancel JG.
I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it was a song she wrote when she was young about a bad relationship, and just released like a 10-minute version of that.
Yeah,
I guess I don't
exactly.
know.
So Gyllenhaal's 41.
You're lying.
He's born 1980.
Wait a minute. By the way, your proof is the calculator.
Yeah, I just typed in numbers.
Jimmy, Brian just showed us the calculator app, and
like,
it said 41.
41.
He's 41, you motherfuckers.
Where the hell that
Hold on.
No, okay. I looked his age up on IMDb.
What is this?
On IMDb, it says he's born 1980. So I subtracted.
Why don't you just Google age? You would say it immediately.
It says it on Wikipedia.
You know how
it literally says
it
on Wikipedia.
Off the top of your head.
Yeah, so he's 41. He's 41 and she's what, 33?
Spell Gyllenhaal. Spell Gyllenhaal.
You want me to?
Yes.
How much will you give me if I spell it on the first try?
I will down a White Claw.
Okay, that sounds fun. Ready?
Okay.
G-Y... Wait.
No.
Hold on.
No, he had it.
Hold on, ready?
Okay.
Gyllenhaal.
Yeah.
Yeah, down that fucking White Claw right now, you son of a bitch.
Once again, on three, Brian is wrong. One, two, three.
I didn't say you.
Brian is wrong. Actually, he was right. He's 41.
Yeah, he's 41. Look at the calculator.
Is there one in there? Do I have to go get one?
I don't know.
Oh, we're out of White Claw.
Wait, who wants to call in?
Someone wants to explain it.
Oh, Kat. Yeah, Kat, call in. Please, Kat.
I feel like I go off the mic because I don't know how your production works exactly. I don't want to, like... I don't want to like call
been,
it out.
We don't have a production the camera this whole time. What do you?
I don't know how it works. Let's get someone's thoughts.
Yeah. Here. So, oh wait. Taylor Swift is our age then.
She's like 33 or something, isn't she?
Roughly.
I think she's a little older.
Oh, she's 30, older than
1989. So she's like 32.
Yeah.
Yes. What are you?
31. Eric. Oh, I am 30. I'm 30. 91.
Kat, if you know
so
the
she's
number,
99.
Call
so she's 32.
32.
Probably. Or 33. No, isn't her birthday November?
I don't
her birthday?
Know.
Did her birthday just pass?
I have no idea.
I people are talking about it.
That Jake Gyllenhaal was not there for her 21st birthday.
Whoa! What does that mean? Wait, yes. What's this?
That's what I was in the song, I believe.
Are you connected right to Bluetooth?
Yeah,
my phone is.
How oh, you know
is?
That?
Yeah.
Oh shit!
Hold on, Kat. Stand by. For
stand
listening.
By. Can
hold
you
on,
just connect
on,
yours
hold
real
on,
quick?
Hold on, not you, Kat. Don't worry. You
yeah,
just
Kat,
stay
you
right
stay
there.
On.
You stay right there. We'll cue you up.
For
shortly.
Once, I'm right. I'm good.
Yeah,
you are connected to the Bluetooth.
It says iPhone. Kat, can you hear us?
No, it shouldn't say iPhone. It should say Bluetooth. Roadcaster.
Oh, okay. Yeah, disconnect. Yeah. Still,
looks
why
like
would
Christian's
you stop
wrong
to do that? I've done my part.
I've done my part.
Yeah, it says iPhone. I'm holding an
right,
iPhone.
Hold on, Kat. Stay on.
Kat,
stay
if
on.
You're listening, you're doing great. Don't worry about it. Okay, guys. Look,
stand by.
I believe I've hit stand all by the points.
And also, you guys are getting your next TikTok right now. four dumbass fucking straight white males get told off about Jake Gyllenhaal wronging Taylor Swift a decade ago and deserving to be hated forever.
She relives it on SNL for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
It's on. It's up now.
Okay. It's not popping up for me.
Oh, weird.
Okay.
Where's my white claw?
We're going to have to...
that's a seltzer. That's a Michelob Ultra.
I don't think there's any more white claw.
No.
I'll go get
no,
one.
There definitely is. There's more in there. There's got to be.
About a whole stack.
We're going to watch him down a white claw
so
shortly.
So she's 31. Her birthday's in December.
Yes, I just saw that.
Wait.
Phony.
December. Fake. 10-year difference.
Right, I thought her birthday
difference
was like the 13th or some shit. That's like her number.
What's wrong,
I grew up a huge Britney Spears fan, and her birthday's
just
December
hold it
2nd.
Up, hold it up to the phone while I go get the white claw.
Wait,
Kat,
just
you don't have to get the white claw. That's not the problem.
Don't worry about
it's
the white
not,
claw.
No,
here.
No, yeah,
okay.
Just, here you go. It's not connected
this
to Bluetooth?
No, it's not even popping up.
Why don't we try to make it work so we can hear her very clearly?
Yeah, right.
Let's get it right. Let's get it right. Hold on, Kat.
1 second. Just hold on, Kat. We'll get you.
We appreciate you.
Now it's discoverable.
There you go.
It's
discoverable. Oh, that's cool as hell.
Yeah, this thing
holy
is fucking
shit
technology wonderful.
Amazing, yeah.
I mean, it's
dude,
something else.
It's a radio station in a little box.
Man.
How awesome.
My Tinder
is that
bio. All right, that's fucking awesome.
Oh, God.
Let's see if it works.
We're getting there now. Kat, you're doing great once again. You're doing
once
fantastic.
Again, she's waiting. She can't even hear us, though.
All right, Kat.
Yeah, there's the title. Four himbos talk about
Kat, can you hear us now?
Himbos?
It's quiet, but I hear it. Left side.
Bring it up.
It's in my west side.
You say it? Kat, can we hear you?
I can hear you.
Right. Oh, I hear Kat. Hi, Kat. How are you?
I'm going to go get that white claw. I want you to down it.
Kat,
hi,
we're just going to have you just start talking. Because
yeah, we're listening.
A bit
we're
of
listening.
A delay, so you just go off and make fun of Brian, okay? You, whenever you're ready, you just go right ahead.
Oh, she just said she can't hear us. I think a second ago
she can't hear us.
Oh, what happened?
Let me see this. Let me see Kristen's phone.
Oh, Jesus!
Here,
all right.
Phone.
We're so. I
hold on, Kat. We're so sorry, but we're gonna make this work.
I'll connect
pretty well.
Oh, she just said I can't hear now. God damn it! Here we go.
Can't hear. All right, Kristen's connected to Roadcaster Pro.
Well, I mean, I think we've nailed it so far. I think we've really covered all the bases.
Jake Gyllenhaal was right. I'm pretty sure that would get you canceled more than saying a slur right now.
Yeah, right now.
If you say Jake Gyllenhaal was right, if you tweet that, I think you'd actually get canceled more than if you said something really bad.
All right, so Kat,
I also, by the
there
way, I'm saying that as a joke. I don't know anything.
No.
Why would I know or fucking care about Taylor Swift and Jake Gyllenhaal's relationship for
I'm
a decade
tweet that
ago
right now from the Wangers.
Why would I know? Quote me.
I'm just going to cut the part out. Jake Gyllenhaal's right.
There's a soundbite. All right, sorry. Kat's trying to connect. I hear her.
We were muted.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Right? You can hear us?
I think we have her now.
Kat.
I can hear you.
Okay.
Here we go. Okay, we can hear you. All right, we're going to shut
it
the hell up. We're going to we want to hear you out.
Please explain.
Also,
us
can you please tell us who you are? Tell us what, like, you're a fan of Taylor Swift, or how does this go?
Where are you
from? Then tell us what it's about.
Hi. Yes, this is Kat. And yes, I found Eric first and I found y'all for earlier. Yes, karaoke got me into this show.
Nice. Okay.
And yes, as the chat can attest, anybody in the Discord can attest, I am a very big Taylor Swift fan. Very big, yeah. I have all the answers to all the questions you've been asking.
Okay.
Right, where should I start?
Yeah, okay. Where should
What's
we start?
What's the first question that we have for Taylor Swift?
I just want to ask the chat and just make sure you guys can hear Kat fine, right?
They can hear.
Okay, just making sure. Okay.
Anything we can hear, yeah, they can hear.
Anything I can do,
so
can do better.
So why did Taylor Swift perform this song again?
Okay, so one of the reasons it's a big deal now is because it initially was a 10-minute song. She was at a band rehearsal, and she was like in the midst of the breakup, and it was very, very raw and fresh. And she just started playing, and it just started coming out. And they recorded the 10-minute version, and she had that initially. And they were like, "Well, we can't put a 10-minute version on your album, so let's shorten it." And so the shorter version is what we got when Red was initially released. And then with the whole trying to get her masters and re-recording so that she can own her music again, she figured for all of these songs that didn't make the cut or what have you, she figured she would just release whatever she had. Like, she would release all the unfiltered, however long it is. And this song was also one that she admitted was really special to her and the fans. I can attest because it's my favorite song of hers.
Oh,
so I've heard it before.
It's a fan favorite.
Okay.
That's why. She's
are we
like,
going to do a live react to this? I've never even heard this song.
It's
a very long song.
God, it's 10 minutes.
But we cut you off though. Keep going. Sorry, we just cut you off.
The song is amazing, and
it's too long.
Yeah, it's like, and technically it's old news, but also it's very nice old to hear her not have to hold back about the shit that she went through. Regardless of whether or not Jake needs to be attacked on Twitter right now, I'm like in my own listening to it in my room, I'm like, yeah, fuck him, but I'm not like attacking online.
Whatever.
He's
still really hot. I mean,
it's pretty gorgeous.
That's true.
But what did he gorgeous do?
We don't need to hold on, Brian.
What, Brian?
No, just no. Can we respond to what Kat just
told us?
Let's first respond to what Kat just told us.
I wasn't listening. I'm sorry.
What else is new?
You fucking imbo son of a bitch.
What else is new?
No. I will say this.
Brian, the one time you've listened to me was the one time months ago I mentioned excitedly that I played the Blockbuster game because of y'all. I mentioned one time that I was high, and you held it over me for months now.
It's kind of what he does.
Wow, Brian.
I hold on to things.
I think Kat's working on a song about you, you piece of shit.
So, don't worry, I'll hear it in 20 years.
Brian, I will say, you know, Brian, if I was high right now, maybe I'd find you funnier.
Oh! Let's fucking go. I wish that was open. I wish that white glove was open.
I checked that it was closed.
Okay, wait, Kat, can I just say that the story you just told us is fucking awesome. I love the idea that she had a 10-minute version back in the day when she was, would it be like 19, did we say? 19, 20, something like that?
I'm 19.
It's the year 2010.
It went through, because that was also it was a on-again, off-again thing, as the fun things are, and which was one of the reasons I think it was such an intense emotion, because he's also the one that the Never Ever Getting Back Together song is about. So it started at like 19.
That song was about him too. Then we're never going to get back together.
The whole album about him.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was about John Mayer.
And then, like she says in the song, because it started when she was like 19, but it also says in the song that like he was supposed to show up to her 21st birthday and didn't show.
Cody got that right.
Cody said that. Cody knows what he's talking about.
So he was going to show up to when she can buy alcohol when he was already in his 30s.
Yes.
Okay, but so I do.
Yes. Okay,
wait,
okay.
I love the idea though. But even Jake Gyllenhaal aside, like fuck him, whatever. Who cares? I like the idea just on a professional level that the thing that stood out to me from what Kat just told us. Right. I don't know about you guys. Mm-hmm. Is that she had a song? All right, Brian, we know you're an asshole. She had a song that was like 10 minutes long,
yes.
And understandably, the label was like, yeah, right. The label was like, well, we're not going to put that out. Totally
what is
reasonable.
This, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. So Kat, correct me if I'm wrong. She must have put out a shorter version of it. Then is that the idea?
Yeah, so actually both versions are on the re-release of Red, but the one that we knew was a much shorter, it's like maybe, I can actually check right now, but it's like maybe like 5 or so minutes.
So is this the first time we've heard the 10-minute version that with this re-release?
Live?
Yes,
See, that is really cool. If it were like one of my favorite bands or something like that, that would be fucking incredible.
Yeah, that'd be dope. I get it now. You know, I'm on board now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And all you had to do was listen, Brian.
I want to hear the extended edition of Shake It Off.
Yeah.
Sure.
That's the only song I know. The extended version of Shake It Off is the real hard hitter. I'm sorry. I don't know any of the songs.
The original All Too Well is 5 minutes, 29 seconds. And nothing has changed. It's just, there was like in this one, there's like extra bridges and she just had so much to say. And it's just like a lot more.
She just sings the song twice.
We're going to play that one again.
The people at SNL were literally like clapping, thinking it was over.
Right, I heard that. Yeah. I heard that. Well, but people don't know that. And she only took one slot.
Yeah, she didn't do two songs.
No, so that makes sense, like a Prince treatment.
But my thing is also like, regardless, even it doesn't matter who the song's about. We'd want to hear it regardless. It just so happens that it's the famous actor.
So I think it was about some guy from high school named Joe.
Like. But also, let's be clear. Taylor Swift is not perpetuating that. I'm sure it's younger fans probably mostly talking about it on Twitter. Like, drag him. And he's literally like, he's a 40-year-old man that is not on Twitter and probably doesn't know this is happening.
Couldn't give a shit.
He couldn't give less of a shit.
But is he married or anything?
I don't think Taylor Swift really cares that much either, to be honest with you.
You go ahead. Oh, I think we're going to say the same thing.
Do you think either of them care? They're grown adults now.
You would hope not.
Kat, go ahead.
It's kind of funny because she has this line in the 10-minute version of like, I get older, but your lovers stay my age. And right now he has somebody who's like early 20s.
Wait. That's in the extended version?
Yes.
Yeah.
But it was written back then?
How does that make sense, Kat?
How does time work?
The extended version is the original version. She just cut it down.
So here's my question. So she wrote the original version, though, like right after that breakup?
Yeah, she was in the midst of all that. And like I said, she was at a band rehearsal and just kind of started playing.
And she predicted. This was right after they broke up. She said, your girlfriends stay the same age? How did she know that?
She date Leo, too?
She assumed.
She's making a guess. I don't know if it was that he dated somebody shortly after that one. Not necessarily like looking at facts. It's just she's kind of saying, or maybe it was people he dated before. I don't know if every single thing is coming from facts or just the fact of like you're already dating somebody significantly.
In fairness, it also might have just rhymed, right?
Yeah, it's just been like I'm older, you're the same age.
That's right. She was trying to rhyme with minimum wage or something. I don't know.
Yeah, you're in a lot of rage.
I'm with Tay Tay. Yeah. I'll side with Tay Tay. I think guys dating young girls is kind of gross.
She's not going to kiss you, bro.
but you white knight bastard.
We got something else from Kat here.
Go ahead, Kat.
There's more.
But she was also saying that something that was great about re-releasing things is that she's getting this chance to do what fans have been asking for years, because she was saying like this time, since the fans know most of the music that was re-released, she saw how important the song was to people, and she was saying how now when she sings this song, it's just like happiness as opposed to when she first sang it and could barely sing it because it was so emotional. Now it's just this connection with fans, and like me, it's like some of the lyrics are just so powerful, and it's just that raw emotion. It's like, who cares? Like, yeah, when I jokingly will be like, yeah, fuck him. And like,
yeah, fuck him. I would totally, too. Yeah.
All right, Christian, hold on. Yeah,
yeah. He's not going to fuck you, bro.
I obviously can't speak to who he is. Like, we saw something on Twitter that he was a very bad tipper, like Brian.
Did you say tipper or kisser?
Both.
Tipper.
Well, yeah.
I'm bad at both.
Brian's admitting to both.
I've been exposed on Twitter for both.
Kat. Go ahead.
And she just I know she just loves storytelling, and I think the short film version is so good. And
good filmmaking.
If you have this 10-minute song that you can see as a 15-minute video, like why not?
Look, as a fan of you've been dancing in his seat trying to say something. Slow and steady wins the race, pal.
Go ahead.
I'm just gonna say that I'm reiterating what I said. I think, yeah, aside, so I didn't know all this. Yeah. Aside from the Jake Gyllenhaal of it all, like, who gives a shit? Just as a fan, getting to hear an extended version of a song that was the original version. Sorry, not the extended version, but the original version of a shortened song.
That wasn't radio friendly.
That is so fucking cool. I did not know that. Yeah. I didn't quite understand that this, I didn't know that it was like extended or whatever. Like, for all I knew, it was like a new version of it.
It was a little long.
That is so cool. So I'll give you that. Like, that is fantastic. I think that's awesome. I didn't know that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I have all the Taylor Swift answers you could possibly need or not even want. I have them all.
Christian's been holding off, trying to get it worded. Yeah.
Christian's been dancing in his seat like a little schoolgirl. Is that what they do?
They dance in their seat.
Or I'm coming at this generally ignorant, okay? Because
you're in a safe space. You're not getting canceled. Go
either
ahead.
Way, it's wrong. Okay,
she's not gonna fuck you.
No, I don't know anything that really that much about Taylor Swift other than the fact that, like, I feel like whenever I see a new song come out from her, I feel like the talk is it's a breakup song or it's all about a relationship.
Yeah,
I could be wrong about that, but please correct me if I'm wrong. And that's what it kind of seemed like to me. It just kind of seemed like treading on old things. But your explanation for kind of her approach to it not being so emotional, but now, like, we can finally address this as a situation.
Take the power back.
It's not treading on old things. It is an old thing that's being made public for the first time. That's the point.
Yeah. Yeah.
She didn't come back and write a song like, hey, I dated Jake Gyllenhaal for a week and he stunk like ass, and now I'm going to sing about it. Like, it's an old song.
Yeah. That's where I was confused about
it. I didn't know that.
I didn't know it was about Jake.
Cody
has her hand.
And to be fair,
I have no idea.
And to be fair, when she's a teenager in her...
To be fair to Jake?
No, to Taylor. To bring up Christian's relationship.
Mind yourself, counselor.
When you're a teenager and in your early 20s, relationships are kind of a big deal, so you're going to write your songs about that shit.
Tell it to Olivia Rodrigo.
Yeah, it's the end of the world for you, but everyone else, it's just like a normal day thing. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All right, so all right. Yeah. Shake it off. Just shake it off.
I will say that even though at this point she had, like, a lot of it is just people... Because her love life has been so public, and because honestly, there's pictures from one day they had. Like, it's kind of like because of all the like investigating the fans have done, like, it's kind of obvious it's about him. Mm-hmm. But people constantly ask her, and it's like the kind of thing of like she's not trying to be like, yes, it's like she doesn't actually address like, yes, it's about him and about this. It's just kind of like
she should not deny
it, but she's just like. Like, and even in interviews now where they're like, oh, tell us who it's about. And she's like, you know, at this point, it's for everybody. Like,
okay, it's an empowerment.
It's about my stepdad. It's actually about my stepdad at the time.
Like, even if she has, like, hints here and there, she never has actually said, like, this is about so-and-so.
Okay. Well, good. That makes me feel better about it, honestly.
Yeah. No, so, like, to know that
the reason he was trending is because, like, fans are just, like, speculating and shit-talking is better than to know that it's, like, officially coming from her.
Yeah.
She's not egging it on, like, hey, fucking
that would be fucking
Jake.
Weird, okay. Man.
That was my point. Like, when I was watching it on SNL, I was like, why is she digging up this old stuff? Like, why do we care about this? In coinciding that with Twitter as well, and, like, people losing their minds over a scarf or whatever the fuck.
So is she dating? Is she happy now? Is she living
She's dating
life?
A London boy.
Gonna, Who's the London? Harry Styles?
That's a different song.
I was going to say, because honestly, she said a while back that... one of her concerns for all because people in interviews would constantly ask her, like, well, what are you going to do once you're happy with somebody? And
Oh, my God.
You're not
going
to have a music career.
And, I mean, but she's
pretty rude.
She's shown over her past couple albums that she just takes, like, she'll just either take it from friends' experience or movies or something or, like, she'll make up stories. Like, she's, like, her past several albums have, like, all the songs from her recent personal experience are about actually being happy. And, it's just like there's this movie I watched and there's this breakup and like
Kanye West.
And regardless of
remember
and
that
like, and like
nobody focuses on the happy songs.
So we still dredging up old stuff.
Yeah. Has she written a song about the time when Kanye came up there with the
She actually did.
She did write that song?
Yes.
She did.
Is that Shake It Off?
Now and it's on Speak Now and it's called Innocent.
Oh.
There's also a song called This Is Why We Can't Have Nice Things and it's on a different
episode. Oh shit. She's talented. Cool.
Hell, now she's telling you.
Hell yeah! All right, okay. I'm gonna start listening.
Go ahead. I was gonna say, does anybody have any further questions here? I'm looking around the room. I think that answered my questions.
Yeah,
I understand it now.
JJ,
I understand.
I just hear she puts on a great live show.
I'll tell you what though, from what Kat just said, not that I was under the impression that Taylor Swift was like egging this on.
Yeah.
I will say this. Mm-hmm. If she was egging this on, this relationship that lasted a couple of months from over a decade ago, that would be petty.
That'd be
kinda
weird.
Odd.
Yeah.
But what it sounds like is it's mostly the fans,
the internet,
keeping it going, and that's fine, that's expected, whatever. I love the idea that she was able to release this original version of the song been limited until now. Yeah. And I'm honestly jealous because I can think of a few bands that I love that I would love to hear that for.
Oh, yeah. Well, that'd be like Queen's, again, Bohemian Rhapsody being like radio friendly.
I want to hear the original Bohemian Rhapsody, the 30-minute version.
Oh, no, that's like the We Will Rock You, like fast-paced live version. Have you ever heard that one?
No.
Oh,
they have like a long version?
Oh, dude, it's full of cocaine. It's great.
Oh, that's awesome.
But the main thing that Kat helped me understand here is that it's not, I don't know why I thought this because I didn't look into it, but I thought that there was like Taylor Swift like winking at people like it's Jake Gyllenhaal, you know, like, and that would be a little weird.
Whoa,
but if it's mostly the fans interpreting it.
Wait,
hold on, Kat, stand by.
I thought the guy in the video looks like him.
Dylan O'Brien?
Oh, wait, is that true? Did you say, that's right, you did say that.
Well, you guys said that.
No.
Like if you weren't holding a grudge, then why would you cast the guy that looks like the guy?
Okay, to quote the woman that you hate, I'm speaking.
Who's the woman we hate?
He doesn't like
Kamala.
We did it, Joe.
We did it, Joe. We ruined America.
Hey, go ahead, Kat. Go ahead, Kat.
That was Joe Biden.
What she likes doing is she will put in little clues from her, just because she says she loves leaving like little hints for people to figure out. And so like she sings about a scarf, and so she'll show in music videos like what connects certain things, or like when her record label like screwed her over, she'll have things from that. And her, like, she loves leaving little clues.
Passive aggressive.
But it's no.
Eric's shaking his head.
Just Kat's so disappointed. No, Brian. No. No.
Feels a little passive aggressive.
I mean, I would do the same thing if like you can't, like if you're like held behind like some contract thing and you can't say what you want to say, then you would like throw.
Yeah, let's be clear. Like I get it. I would do the same thing as well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead, Kat.
It's also not like she was putting clues from this album, like in music videos from her like most recent album. Like she's putting clues in this, like, because it's from.
Yes.
Yeah. She's like, she like have like a scarf in her video because this is the album where all that stuff got unleashed. Yeah.
I get that, and I agree with that. Yes, I do understand that.
It's
okay.
Not like she's like 20 years. It's not like she's like 15 years later for different songs.
Yeah, like see,
remember how this guy broke my heart?
Yeah. See, I like, again, completely ignorant to the whole situation. Like, I heard the song. I saw a thing on Twitter. I was like, oh, it's another song about a breakup, and then you get context, you get the full story, and maybe, unfortunately, maybe a lot of people aren't gonna like dig deep into it. They're gonna see a headline somewhere, and they're gonna be like, ugh, another song, or they're gonna be like, ugh, Jake Gyllenhaal, asshole. So there's like no middle ground for it. It's gonna be one side or the other.
But also, Kat, I have a question for you.
No.
I have a question for you, Kat.
I'm glad that I know the full
Kat,
context.
Kat has something to say.
We just need one person to talk.
She is talking.
She's speaking.
I do have a question.
Okay. But let her speak.
I'm gonna let you finish. Oh shit!
But I will say, if for anybody who wants to hear me as well as other diehard Taylor Swift fans go on about our knowledge and love for the subject, there's this little known podcast called Nick and Manny's Infinite Podcast.
Put it in the chat.
Now's not the time for plugs. We're asking questions here.
No, you say Nick and Manny?
Nick and Manny.
Yeah, they're from our Discord.
Nick and Manny's Infinite Podcast. Yeah. And Manny has been kind enough to host we're recording it maybe tomorrow.
He's paying you guys?
Wait a minute. You're going to be on this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God! Wait, what the hell? This sounds great. Okay.
Podcast made a podcast. What? I don't know.
Two other people in this community made a podcast, and me and somebody else made a music duo. It's all magical stuff.
I love it.
Please.
So we partially because I'm so loud. I've been on their podcast before, and I'm very, very loud about the things I love. And Manny mentioned Taylor Swift, and he has other friends who love Taylor Swift. So I was like, if you don't have a podcast about this.
Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah, fair enough.
First of all, rule number one.
We're number one.
Kat, Nick, or Manny, please post that in the chat.
Oh, the
so
link.
People
yeah,
can,
yeah, yeah.
can go and subscribe to their podcast feed. Also, perfect. Or YouTube channel where they post all the podcasts. Also, two, neither myself, Cody, or Brian, or I guess Eric now.
Don't talk for me.
Have it. Okay, Daddy. Have not been invited.
Yeah, almost forgot my name.
Yeah, what the hell? That? We haven't been on this thing.
What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this?
Kat, I do have a question for you.
Post it in the chat, please.
I have a question. Then we'll get to plugs. Oh, yeah. You had a question.
This is my last question. I can't think of anything else because you've honestly explained it all. Yeah. You did exactly what we wanted you to do. Thank you so much, Kat. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
But here's the question. Do you think that Taylor and Jake have corresponded about this at all? Do you think Jake Gyllenhaal gives the slightest shit about this? Do you think that all press is good press? Like, what do you think in the real world, aside from like the fan reaction? He doesn't give a shit about this,
more
right?
And importantly,
she, I don't promoting
think,
and his
I,
movie.
Well, I don't well, think she really cares either, right? I think it's more for like the fans.
More
what do you
importantly,
think?
What is Antoine Fuqua?
Yeah, that's
true.
Yeah.
But what do you think in the real world, like behind closed doors? You know, you remember like years ago when we found out that Taylor and Kanye chatted about that song. Or whatever.
No.
Like, do you think that they've talked behind the scenes? And or do, if they haven't talked, do you think that Jake Gyllenhaal gives a shit?
Oh,
like,
wasn't
what do you
there
think
recordings
is the deal?
Of Taylor talking to Kanye?
But what do you think is the deal with that cat? Like on the real.
Monica Lewinsky. That's what that Linda Tripp.
Clinton.
Do you know what I mean though? Like we can all speculate, but what do you think is the real deal?
I don't think they've chatted because she has been pretty open about there's certain like exes that she's like, at this point, she's like, I'm saying them baby gifts and stuff because it was a different time. We were young and did these things.
19.
Now like they're happy. And like, and
35.
Then, and then someone mentioned in an interview, asking about like what these guys might think now. She's like, I honestly haven't thought about them once. So
right.
Like at this point, she's just, so I feel like at this point, because she can typically be, she can kind of be a little coy and elusive.
Definitely. I know what you mean. Yeah, I get you.
Typical Tay Tay.
If she's trying to dance around like, oh, we might have, or like she'll be kind of vague of like, I got an angry email or something. Like she'll typically say that kind of thing if something has happened recently. And this one, she was just kind of like, I haven't thought. And at this point, it's just like, here's my music and it's finally mine. Here's what the fans want. Here's this music I wanted to share in the first place. So now it's for me and the fans. They love it. It's like it's their song as much as it is mine, which she says for Laughing Music at this point. So I really don't think it's her being like, let's see what he has to say about this now.
Right. Well, he's not. I mean, that's a good thing because there's no world in which he would ever acknowledge or respond to this.
Yeah.
No.
Tweet out the other day, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah. He's like a grown man. They're both grown adults.
Well, Kat, I appreciate you.
Not on Twitter.
You calling in and letting us. Because I didn't even know a music, like the music company rights for album.
I didn't know that. She didn't
own her masters.
She's re-releasing all her albums because she didn't own them.
I just knew Shake It Off. That's
no, but
all
she,
I,
like, she like re-recorded.
That's all I fucking know.
Yeah, I just wanted to
Shake
It Off.
And that's a separate issue. That's awesome. That's fantastic.
Good for her.
I did not know that this was originally the length of the song was a 10-minute song that they cut down. That's fucking awesome that she just put that out now. That's my big thing that I learned, and I'm very pleased with that. That's cool.
But I thought like no musician owns their own masters.
Not, well, but now she
recently,
does.
But now
she does.
But not just her, but like any musician, like signs over. Didn't her dad like own a record company?
She said that in a recent interview. She was like, unfortunately, a lot of musicians don't own their own.
But I do.
She said that she kept saying how important it was for her to own her masters, which especially makes sense when she wrote all her own songs. And then they were sold to somebody else who had been who was not a positive influence. Who was
I know about that.
It was sold to Jake Gyllenhaal.
No.
Is that what happened? He owned the masters.
No, Jake Gyllenhaal doesn't own the masters.
Yeah,
Brian,
and a scarf.
But no, I do know about that. That's right.
Something I do appreciate is she has said that with the record label that she has now. I think one of her like clauses for her signing with them was that it would be an ongoing thing for anybody else they sign. I believe she signed. They would get either the chance to own their masters, or they would automatically get their masters. So she was like, when she signed with her current record label, she was fighting for like everybody else to have their own masters as well.
Yeah,
right.
That's a whole other world too of signing with record companies.
Yeah, that's a whole other topic. I knew about that
because like Metallica recently, because they wanted to print their stuff on vinyl, they had
a Metallica's version album.
Well, yes,
Taylor's Garage Band,
Master of Puppets, Taylor's version.
That was the thing for the longest time of them not owning their own music, but they finally attained the rights to all of it too. But that's
Metallica didn't have the rights to
not for a while.
I thought that was like normal when you sign your
and they're trying to change it. They're trying to change it
Macklemore was like an independent.
She's trying to change it. That's part of what she's doing.
She's trying to shake it off.
Trying to shake it off.
She wanted to get down to this.
Kat, this was fantastic. Thank you.
I learned.
There's so many better songs than Shake It Off. You gotta.
It's the only one he knows.
Listen to Styles. Styles, great.
What the hell, Styles?
That's the Harry
Styles. Wildest Dreams.
His name's. She dated Harry Styles too.
Yeah, that's the Harry Styles.
All right, well, we can't get into this right now. We can't get into Harry Styles. Jesus.
Oh, I wonder if the song about.
Hold on.
The song called Style is about Harry Styles.
I was about to spoil something. I can't say. Never mind.
Great song.
I'm gonna say a thank you for informing us dumb
once again
boys.
Yeah, I didn't know all the details. That's cool.
I'm not going to listen to any of the songs, but I'm glad that I know the full context of the situation because I see it all differently. Now, neither Tay-Tay or JJ are the villain.
J-Gay.
But no, I didn't say that.
It's a J and a G. All right.
But the Stews are the Vill-Vills, if you know
who's
what I'm saying. The Studios.
Oh.
And the villains.
You know Stews.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Kat.
Would you possibly listen to a Taylor Swift song if Bobcat did a cover?
I would do that.
Sure.
Now's not the time for promotion.
Stay tuned. Subscribe to Bobcat.
Go to our Discord.
Manny, put that in the chat as well.
Yeah, Manny's here again.
Thank you, Kat.
Thank you, Kat. We very much appreciate you. And have a good rest of the week, yo. Stay warm.
Thank you all for letting me call in. Y'all are the best. And it's cool to get to talk to all of you, considering like that I started with Eric and now I'm big fan of all y'all.
Oh, okay.
Also, we'll see you on the 17th, right, for karaoke too.
Yeah, you better be there. You better not be seeing Spider-Man.
Of course.
Okay, good.
We got her.
Also,
we got
James, Tay-Tay. James won't forgive me. He said, "Tell Eric to make merch and watch Mamma Mia." So I just have to say that.
Two things I've addressed in our Discord already. We're trying.
Get in that.
We're trying. God damn it. We're trying.
Right. Thank you, Kat. Appreciate you.
Get in that Discord.
Leave him alone, guys.
Bye, Kat.
All right. Bye.
All love, one love, Quest love. Bye.
Hey, there you go. It's sticking. Look, it's sticking.
Oh, it's been sticking.
It's stuck. I know.
Yeah. Nice. That was it.
Right. I will say somebody in the chat did say that, you know, the whole audio of
oh, who's on the left side?
No. That's what I'm saying. The audio of the Taylor and Kanye conversation on the phone, it did come out that she wasn't like lying about anything. I'm just saying my point is that we didn't know that she was on the phone with Kanye before that song came out.
What did it?
So that's why I'm wondering. I wasn't accusing her of like lying or something like that. It's just a matter of like that song came out after they chatted. Whether or not it was made clear is fine. But that's why I was asking. I wonder if like she and Jake behind the scenes. I wonder if she's like, "Hey, my people talk to Jake's people. Hey, we're doing a thing. Don't worry about it. We're just appeasing the fans kind of deal." Like, I don't know if they've talked.
Maybe. I think in general, across the whole
Gyllenhaal.
Yeah, and across the whole entertainment industry, if there's like a beef or anything, it's all manufactured just to sell everything.
Oh, they'll conspire.
Yes. If there's beef, if there's it's like his movie's coming out, she's got a new album. I don't know.
Incidental.
Yeah, like it's
she
all.
She has a new album out now, yes.
I saw Maggie tweeting about it too. It was weird.
Yeah, she's got a new movie out.
Why did I believe that? She goes, "My brother's a dick."
But yeah, it's all just like, hey, let's like throw this out there and see what people talk about.
Julie in the chat brought up, is there an extended edition of Lights Out? Your hit song that you put out on YouTube?
Interesting.
I want to hear a whole 8-minute version of Lights Out.
No, there's not. Actually, it's funny. The version that's out is the extended version because the original version was only the chorus.
Thank you.
Okay.
So now the whole thing is out.
Okay. All right.
That's fun. Thank you for asking. That's sweet.
I like the song.
You know it? Yeah, you know it, right? Yeah, of course.
We all know that.
Listen, there's a lot more songs that I've written in high school. Like, there's a lot more songs I wrote in high school. And maybe I'll bring them back. Eric's version.
Are you going to bring a guitar to the Wangers karaoke?
Or is it all keyboard?
What if I told you that might be on my ideas?
Don't give us ideas.
All right. I'm just saying you have to prep because I got to get a mic ready for it.
What if I told you I'm going to mime it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's going to be fake. Yeah, it's going to be like not plugged in anything.
Don't worry about it.
Okay, okay. Then totally fine. Totally fine.
I don't know
fine.
Why yeah. when he said mime it, I started doing the robot.
What if I told you in the shower today, I actually like did this along with the
I was doing that.
Look at this preview.
Let's watch Christian do the robot.
I do the robot when we
say
mime.
Why? Are you going to mime it? Are you going to mime it?
It's
going to
mime it in about 3, 2. I don't know why I did that.
What am I doing with my hands?
We're going to start wrapping things up here because we're not going.
It's almost 3 hours.
I got to cheat again. We're not going to do that. We're going to get the fuck out of here.
What is that?
Sorry, I'm just moving the shirt.
Okay. We are going to read some Streamlabs and some Super Chats. And
can I go to the bathroom real quick before you start?
Yeah.
I don't want to miss that, but I have to pee so bad. Do you want to pee between my legs?
No.
Come with me.
I can go underneath?
We're going to make you say all the names, so don't worry. Don't worry, sweetie.
Oh, God, I've been nervous because you guys have like barely made it out of here.
Oh, yeah. It's all South Korean names,
too. It hits like the tripod.
Yeah. There you go. You got it.
We're going to do some Streamlabs and Super Chats real quick. Steak Sauce donated via Streamlabs, so thank you, Steak Sauce. We appreciate that.
You're good, buddy. You're good. You're good.
Please close it.
Oh.
It's okay. Hold.
It's good. You're good. You're good.
Steak Slash also donated via Streamlabs once again. Can you have Cody read the first verse and pre-chorus of Silk Sonic Smoking Out the Window, please and thanks?
What's that?
Okay, I've seen them talk about this in the Discord. What is this?
I have no idea. Smoking Out the Window, it's called?
Silk Sonic Smoking Out the Window, please and thanks.
Oh, I gotta pee so bad.
Didn't you pee already?
Yeah.
Wow, your bladder is really small.
Look at these four White Claws.
Okay. Did you down
okay.
one?
Okay.
I did, kind of.
All the way to the pre-chorus? Is what we're dealing with?
Yeah. Steak Sauce said first verse to the pre-chorus.
Okay.
I don't know
if
that's labeled on Genius.
Should I do the intro from Bootsy Collins? Should I do that? I guess I will.
Yeah, why not?
Here we go. Wait a minute. This love started out so tender, so sweet. But now she got me smoking out the window. On to verse one. Must have spent 45,000 up in Tiffany's. Oh, no. Got her badass kids running around my whole crib like it's Chuck E. Cheese. Whoa, whoa. Put me in a jam with her ex-man in the UFC. Can't believe it. Can't believe it. I'm in disbelief.
Oh.
On to the pre-chorus.
Bars.
Okay.
Is this a rap?
This bitch got me paying her rent, for trips, diamonds on her neck, diamonds on her wrists. Doesn't rhyme.
Martha Wayne.
And here I am all alone. Mm. I'm so cold. You got me out here. There we go.
Am I missing something?
I mean, I said this bitch got me paying her rent.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a good line. Uh-huh. Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. I have to check out the song, mm-hmm. maybe for context, mm-hmm. or pay attention to the Discord a little bit more.
Yeah.
Senior Film donated his weekly. Ooh. Thank Woo-woo. You, Senior. Thank you, Nilo. I appreciate that. Cy Air donated via Streamlabs, saying, "Woo, the boys from Latino Paranormal Activity are back, .. and Cody. Will you guys be doing another group commentary soon?" Well, we did announce that we are doing on our Patreon. We did a commentary for Adam Sandler Values. Adam Sandler Values. You should check it out. Patreon.
It's got to be a thing.
It should be. Patreon.com/wangers. But Cy mentioned Latino Paranormal Activity. I did want to mention. There is a Paranormal Activity documentary on Paramount Plus.
Oh, I want to see that.
I still
that.
Have to watch it. He's been hyping it up.
I want to see it.
Do you get a kickback, man? You're hyping this up.
Amazing.
Oh, man.
I've been wanting to watch it.
Do it for free. Pledge for a week. I don't know what it is.
Paramount Plus.
Okay. Watch it. It's a fantastic documentary. Okay. I loved it. Oren Peli. Just a guy. Just a fucking guy. Just a human being that was like, I'm going to make a movie.
I know we're wrapping up, but I did crack another drink.
That's fine.
Fuck it.
The outro takes 30 minutes. It's okay.
Julia sent the super chat. Eric Striffler, give us the merch.
I guess he's already addressed it,
guys. We're talking. I'm trying.
I'm sorry. Okay.
We want to get. No, it's not a secret. I've talked about it. We're trying to get. What we've done in the past is just drops. Like we do like drops like, you know, like a week or two long sale.
Drop it like a
We want to get a full on store going, but we want to do it with the people we've been working with for almost a decade.
Sure.
We've been working with a company for almost a decade. So, you know, Olin Rogers.
Yes.
It's his company. We've been working with them for almost a decade now.
Oh.
And I want to keep working with them. So we're doing it properly with them. We're making it like actually like a full thing.
Balloon shop himself.
Absolutely.
Oh, man.
And I don't know. He doesn't necessarily do the day to day at this thing, but you know, it's his lovely wife Rachel is mostly running this thing.
Oh my god!
But so point is that we don't want to just do drops.
Okay.
And it would be easy enough to just, you know, like to upload to like a website or something like that. But we want to keep working with them, and we're working on that. I swear to God, we're working on it, but we're doing it properly.
I will say now
it's getting into this time of the year when it's most busy buying merch and stuff like that. Yeah. So right. We're working on it. We're doing the best we can. I swear.
You've worked with him before, and I'm a huge fan. I haven't seen his animated show.
Final Space. It's over. Now you can catch up. It's over. Yeah. Well, the HBO? Final season is coming out or is out? I forget.
One of the two.
I think it's coming. It's or, okay. I okay. I actually forget. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Julia once again sent a super chat. Merch and Mamma Mia. So we talked about the merch. I don't know what this Mamma Mia.
Mamma Mia. We talked about that in the stream. Excuse me. I'm drunk. No. We talked about that in the Discord as well.
Ooh. Boom. There it is. Julia once again via super chat. Really won. Eric Schriffler, you coward.
Oh, coward.
Where is the merch? AJ. Where is Mamma Mia?
What a shame to like read them all in succession after I answered them the first time.
No. Answer again as if it's the first time.
Then also I'm happily. We've talked about this in the Discord. It's not a secret. Join the Discord. Be on my Discord.
We appreciate this.
And the Wangers Discord. Both great Discords.
Jack.
Join the Patreon.
Guarda. Guadira? Jack Guadira?
Hey, Jack.
I think. Super chat.
We know Jack.
Guadira.
Wait, did you intentionally... Guadira, 1954. Did you intentionally schedule the next karaoke for the Spider-Man No Way Home comes out?
It is actually... I didn't even think about it until someone pointed it out tonight. I had no idea.
We might go see it together. All as a
group.
On the 16th.
Oh yeah. Well, so I'm ready to buy. I talked to my other pal that's like got a group.
Yeah, your business partner, Julia.
Yes. No, I we might be going to see it on the 16th. And if not, whatever, I'll figure it out.
Do they still do like? It's not midnight, right? It's like 7 o'clock release. Yeah.
If I miss it on the 16th, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to try to buy tickets on the 16th and also like simultaneously try to buy tickets for like Monday, like Friday morning when everyone's at school and work.
Yeah.
So like I can't miss it.
Oh, that would be awesome to watch.
I can't miss it.
I might just
early morning
take off that whole Friday just to prep.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, you know, well, so I'll get you tickets as well just in case.
Yeah, fuck it.
Just in case.
Fuck it.
Okay.
Fuck.
No, I'm saying if we miss the 16th, if we don't get these tickets.
No, we'll go both.
If we don't, let's at least do Friday.
No, we're going both.
There's no other option, Eric.
I know what you're saying.
This had to be like how Jake Gyllenhaal treated Dave.
That's a miscommunication.
There we go.
That's all it is.
Never listens.
James the Nerd donated via Super Chat. PMI Discord wants to know when we're getting the 10-minute Lights Out Eric version. We just talked about that as
I'm glad you guys got paid for this.
Appreciate that.
If anybody wants to send anything, it would be very
That's
much
good, actually. I'm never going to answer any questions until the end.
Until the very end.
Buy it.
Richie donated via Streamlabs. Can't wait for karaoke because of my Filipino blood.
Okay.
Oh,
interesting.
I grew up with a bunch of Filipinos around. Mm-hmm. Filipino friends. They all had karaoke.
They all big karaoke fans. Alex
is a big karaoke.
It was almost like a joke. Like they all had a karaoke machine in their house. It was what?
Sorry, I was just saying this is good. Don't worry about me. I've not had this Michelob Ultra seltzer anyway.
They love it. And they're really good at it.
You didn't have to answer me,
Eric. We're live.
The show's still going.
Fucking trashed.
That's all the Streamlabs.
Nice, thanks, guys.
Should we get Alex to sing a song? Does he have an original song?
I wanted to talk to him about that. Maybe he can sing a song during karaoke. That could be
He'll mime the guitar, though, because he can't really play.
Or cut to a video of him playing.
Be like, and coming up next.
I was thinking about asking him to like be involved somehow.
Yeah,
but
we won't.
We'll see.
Probably not.
I'm gonna be back on the 20th. It sounds like wait. I'll save the time someone tried to clickbait me until then.
Okay. Catfish you.
Clickbait. Did I say clickbait?
You said clickbait, yeah.
Let me say that again. I'll save the story of how someone tried to catfish me until then.
I think I'm just stupid.
I'm also not drunk. I don't know why
that. I was like, what are you talking about?
I was like,
there was no reaction.
That was some joke that like I haven't heard
of. It's a good joke, Eric.
Clickbait.
As we wrap up, we're going to give shout-outs to all of our patrons.
Of
$15 and up because we give a shout-out to them. Following a funny little soundbite after the fact, we'll have Eric read it right now. I do want to say, Eric, thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. This was kind of chaotic, but also chill. This was great.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Yeah.
I truly cannot. Thank you so much for having me on tonight. I cannot wait until Wangers Karaoke 2.0. I'm so excited.
It's going to be a lot of fun. We're very much excited. And Lady Man sent a super chat saying the mummy was just okay.
My shirt begs to differ.
It's pretty great. It's better awesome. Than the Tom Cruise.
Watch the original. It's fucking awesome.
It's amazing. Yeah, it's great. So I want to thank everybody for watching us or listening to us after the fact. Rate, review, subscribe. Spotify, we're on video now. Check us out there. Like the video. Join the Patreon. Join Eric's Patreon. Pretty much it. Do all that stuff. Catch up with all the things. Oh, do you have a new commentary coming out anytime soon? I know you just put out the short. On the pretty much YouTube channel.
The Tiger King one. Yeah, the Tiger King one. Oh, I have a video uploaded for after we collided that I'm waiting. I'm waiting for like half a week now for it to go up. Okay. It's in copyright hell right now. It's coming soon. Unfortunately, the people that give us the most grief with copyright stuff are the ones that I'm dealing with right now. So, yeah. Okay. We're waiting. We're ready for it to go up.
And new season of Tiger King? Maybe?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't announced it, but if you go to shop.prettymuch.it, I mean, it's pretty obvious. It's right there. You can pre-order it. It's coming out on Wednesday.
Oh, okay. You can pre-order it. There it is.
Yeah, nice. I haven't even announced it or anything. It's just there. If anybody sees it, it's there.
Sorry. Bobby donated via Streamlabs saying Kat is the best. That's true. Kat's the best.
She's okay.
You're okay. All right. Yeah. Eric, why don't you go ahead and read some of these names as we give...
some of them or all of them?
You're going to read all of them.
Some of these names. All right.
All of them.
I need to pee. That's why. Start from number one.
We gotta control our bladders, boys.
Aaron J. Lancaster.
Oh, I got to turn it up. Hold on.
Oh, Jesus.
All right, now.
Aaron J. Lancaster.
Can I get a pound of meat?
Aaron Woodley.
Taking their titties out.
Holy shit, there's 100 of these. Hold on. Alec M.S. Young.
Girls have titties?
Oh, back to the... Okay.
Oh, was that you? I thought that was part of the soundbite. Okay. We could do that live, and I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
Actually, nah. No. Alexis Lopez.
You're such a dick, it's hilarious.
Anthony Marrera.
I hid from my family one time.
Anthony Picciarelli?
They have titties.
Again.
Arcadia. I did not know. Did you just say that live?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Arcadio Calistanos.
All right. Hey, ladies.
Castellanos.
All right. Hey, ladies.
Axel the Hungry Hippo. What's that little asshole's name? Hey, that's me. Billy Storl. I can't believe nobody's saying the name of the little fucker. What was that about?
I have no idea.
Bobby Mitchell.
What does the fox say? I don't know.
Brian King. Think of them as countries, dumbass. Oh, was that when I was doing my map? Probably. That was fun.
No, that was about Disney World.
Oh.
Okay. Brian Arsenault.
I.
Robot.
Chris Jones.
Oh, did you make sure you bought a Coca-Zola?
Cindy Perez.
Handies during the panties. Make sure you're sanitized.
That was from last time you were on.
Okay. Claire Stefan.
Big blast and big cocks.
Yeah. Cody Watson. Oh, my God. My dick is shriveled. Oh, in the background. Connor Kennedy. Yes, I was young. Wait, let me hear that again. Yes, I was young. Yes, I was young. I can't even imagine. Yeah. I see Connor Kennedy, right? DJ Red Hot Cox.
Oh, you can suck my balls.
That sounded like South Park. Elena Marie 10. Oh, man, it's on the tip of my ass. What the fuck is the context? Emmanuel Fuentes.
I've never hit from the rough.
You fucking creep. Enrique Cabrales.
My buddy worked at a golf course.
Golf course. Great.
The emphasis, Gabriel J. Leyba.
But you can suck my balls.
Hey, we heard that one. Or does that not matter?
Doesn't matter.
That's okay. Half the sound bites.
Hernan Sebastian. Oh, man, it's on the tip of my ass. Okay. James Chesney. Fuck me in the ass. James Lavario.
You're such a dick, it's hilarious.
Jason Harvey.
West Side?
Oh, hey, that's from tonight.
No, you've
done this before.
He says it multiple times.
Jesus. John Noto.
West Side?
Joseph Tanana.
Is it longer?
JP Beeler. The fuck, dude? It's so crisp. It's crazy how crisp it is. Carl Soderback.
What does the fox say?
Kyle Johnson. Think of them as countries, dumbass. Maris Thornton. Did you just put your hand... Hold on. Did you just put your hand in front of the camera, Christian?
He did.
It's your own show, you fucked up.
Yeah. No.
Asshole.
Audio-only listeners.
Sorry.
Didn't know.
Did I do Carl Soderbeck?
Yes, you did.
Handies during the panties.
Did I do Kyle Johnson?
Sanitized. Handies during the panties. Make sure you're sanitized.
Maris Thornton.
West Side?
Mark Murdoch.
I hid from my family one time.
Matthew Ricard. Yeah, well, nyctophobia is the fear of the dark. Wait a minute. I hid from my family one time. Did we ever talk about when I got lost in Disney? We must
have. That's why.
Is that where that's from? Yeah, okay, so, okay. I was going to say that can't be not related. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I did Matthew Picard, right?
I don't know.
Sure.
Matthew Picard.
What do you smell, a hot dog? Me. Oh, wait, that's not out yet. Never mind. I was going to say, me. Michael Bittner. He's such a loser. It's hilarious. Nick Reeves.
That's what they call big dick energy, folks.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Cody, what's it like?
Unbelievable sound clips from this show. It truly, I know, I mean, like, I hear this every week, but it's incredible. Curse. It's incredible. Nick Wade.
It's Miller time.
Paul Acton.
Does he use this situation to sleep with the sister?
All right, we got 40
wait,
more.
Wait. Oh.
No.
Who was that?
That
was Kat as well. About what?
Dear Evan Hansen.
Question mark.
Wait, let's play it again.
Yeah, one more time. Oh, you want to play again?
Yeah, but have you guys not seen Dear Evan Hansen?
No.
We talked about this before.
But also, she's wrong. Go ahead.
Let's bring it.
Does he use this situation to sleep with the sister?
No.
There was a pause there. There was a pause and a question mark.
All right, just gonna interrupt for a second. What was the? Why did you ask that? What did you mean?
Based off the trailer,
off the movie Dear Evan Hansen.
I've seen it.
He takes.
We just recorded a track for it. It's coming out soon. December.
17? Because he's connected with the brother that kills himself, and he uses that to get closer to the sister.
And she said no.
I want to say he used.
She said
that.
No.
Have you seen it?
No, but I know the premise.
Oh, he for
I would
sure.
Imagine.
He doesn't use it. Oh,
yeah.
You asked if he uses it.
If he uses it to get closer to the sister, that situation.
You made it seem like it was like diabolical. He's like, oh, I'm going to use it.
There's
this
a song called
dying.
He Said that I would argue is basically exactly what you're saying. I disagree with Kat on that one.
Yeah, no. Well, she's like, no?
Mark intended.
I'm going to side with Jake Gyllenhaal.
I mean, I've never seen it, but yeah.
I think the last one I saw was Paul Acton, right?
Sure. Yes. I want to expose myself.
Oh. Ramon Coke or cock? I don't know.
I have a hormone disorder.
Okay.
Real Snacks Attacks.
It looks like semen.
Okay.
I say that a lot.
Yeah.
Robert Gerbig.
Is this how you take your hot dog?
Ruben E25.
I'm taking you down, bitch.
Oh, bring it, bitch.
Bitch. It's still going. Samantha Leon Mendoza.
I'm sure you have a great butthole, Cody.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Sang Lei.
I want to eat that wiener.
Sean Wingblade.
I got marshmallows today.
We have women on this show. Sometimes.
Who's that?
Yeah,
Grace.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, Grace, of course. Did I say Sean Wingblade? Was that the last one?
Yeah, yes. Senior film.
Senior film.
My cat impression is much better than Turkey.
Holy fuck! Space Wolf Lounge.
Oh. Cat wants to call back in again.
She was 12.
Oh, it's called. Sorry, it's called If I Could Tell Her. My bad. She's correcting us. It's not. He said. But he goes. He said, you've got a sexy ass. And he's like saying things that like her brother, she's like, did my brother ever say anything about me? And he's like, he said, you got nice titties. And she's like, that's weird, but I want to fuck you now, Evan.
That's a song?
I'm paraphrasing.
Okay. You're paraphrasing.
Those were the lyrics and we're just not hearing about
but it is, he said that he likes how you flip your hair. And it's like,
titties?
Is my brother into me? Okay. Like, oh, my brother was into me. That's why he killed himself. All right. Steak sauce.
She was 12.
That was the sound bite.
Horrible timing.
Yeah.
Terry Stockwell.
Whores don't get a second chance.
You know where that's from?
Do I ever? Don't spoil it. Or do you, have you? I
didn't. No, what is it from? What is it from? Yeah, is it from? Yeah.
Whores don't get a second chance.
Whores don't get a second chance.
From?
I said Identity.
Yeah.
We did a commentary for that. I showed Miles for his first time, and he'd never heard of it.
Oh, it's fun.
It was great. Right. Great commentary.
So good.
Yeah. Did I just say Terry Stockwell?
Whores don't get a second chance.
Terry G?
Okay. Oh, shit. What do we do? What are we going to do?
It's crooked.
Thaddeus Maximus.
Trump 24. Let's go.
Trump 24 sounds so funny because like you couldn't say Trump 20.
You couldn't say 2024.
No, 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 but also you couldn't have said that in the previous one. You couldn't say Trump 20. You have to say 2020.
2020, yeah.
But now you can say 24.
Yeah.
It's like, that's funny.
Yeah, go ahead.
That's funny. Did I say Thaddeus Maximus? Sorry.
Start from the top.
Oh my. Good afternoon, Yankees.
But I didn't miss any, right?
No,
I said Terry
good,
G. Okay.
Yeah.
TJ Jones.
TJ.
Tyler Eklund.
Ah!
Cody Hall.
Assault.
No.
Let's talk about it.
Cody Hall?
Wiley Todd.
Yeah, that was in there. Oh, sorry. Assault. Wiley Todd.
Let's talk about it.
No, sorry. Wiley Todd.
They want to fuck.
Evan Hansen.
You got to pound out your meat.
Cat.
He begs her not to hit him.
Taylor Swift.
Pulls down his pants, revealing his penis to be actually an anteater. It's a literal anteater.
Taylor Swift.
Oh.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
I'm a lunch whore.
Tom Hiddleston.
DJ Red Hot Cox.
Harry Styles.
They dip their dick in the water a little bit, and then yeah. maybe they'll get a full heart on.
Yeah. We'll see. Hopefully.
Hopefully.
Because I hope I will.
I will, too.
John Mayer.
Arcadio Castellanos.
Joseph R. Biden.
James Bond's gay.
Zach McCordle.
I'm too strong.
That's it. Zach McCorkledale. I don't know if I said it right, but yeah. That's a great last what a name.
Last one. What is it?
Zach McCorkledale.
I did it. One I tried it.
All love. Quest love.
There it is. Is that how you end them?
Yeah.
Is that why? Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. One love. All love. Quest love. Thank you all so much. Be sure to follow Eric on the Instagrams and Twitters. It's just pretty much it now.
Yeah, now it is.
Well,
I've been going for over a decade. I decided to change it recently.
Eric, don't give a fuck. Pretty much.
This is pretty good, man. Mango apricot's not bad.
Okay. Pretty much dot it.
Pretty much dot it.
Well, that's Instagram.
.com.
Pretty much dot it is a website.
A website. Whoa. That's what I was referring to.
Yeah. Okay.
Where you can buy the tracks. You can join the Patreon. You can watch everything. You can go there. YouTube.com/prettymuchit.
Dot it.
Yeah.
.gov.
What's the one that has all your childhood photos that acted like you died?
That was my Instagram.
Okay.
Astrofleric. I didn't act like I died. I turned 30 years old.
It's like, here was Eric.
You're 30.
One.
You're 31. Yes. You're 29?
29.
26, 27.
You're
26.
Now, how old are you?
29.
29. I'm 30. Do you feel like 30's old, Brian?
No.
I feel old.
I'm just getting started, baby.
I feel fucking old.
But why is it? Why do I feel like everyone that's about to turn 30 feels like it's old? And then everyone that's over 30 is like, nah, never mind. I don't fucking feel old.
Because it's 30 and not like 30, you know, two, you know, moving up in the world. Like, you just turned 30.
Do you feel old?
Yeah.
The fuck, man?
Well, he's married with a child.
Yeah, I feel so. Foreign. I feel 47.
I'm not married or with child.
That's fucking sick, dude. Or with child. Or with. Oh, I'm can we glad. Talk about that real quick?
Yeah.
My original idea for the thumbnail for this episode.
Oh.
Announcing?
You're gonna be a parent.
Eric Striffler has an announcement, and I wanted to get a picture of me like holding my belly, and you make me look pregnant. And we were like, "Well, you know, by the way, we should have done it because I thought about we originally we were like, oh, is that like offensive? But then I realized Lil Nas X did it.
Mm. Oh yeah,
we could have fucking done it.
But he's Lil Nas X though.
So
you're Eric Striffler.
Yeah,
and he was a stripper.
Have some confidence, man.
He was giving a lap dance to the devil.
I mean, that's cool.
That's fucking sick.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking cool.
I was going. Yeah, I went on a diatribe in the PMI Discord recently about people turning 30, and then I saw because people are like, "Oh my god, I'm getting old," like you asshole.
Oh, okay.
When you're nearing 30, and it's like, are you just saying that, or do you actually feel old? Mm. Do you?
Yeah.
Do you really feel old?
I mean,
you look like you're 12.
Physically.
I was going to say, like,
physically, I feel old.
All right.
I feel tired all the time, but in comparison to Cody, I feel like I can't.
In comparison to Cody, I'm ready.
No. I'm not saying, I'm saying,
you're
like,
allowed to be tired.
Cody has a child.
Yes,
so that,
he's
like,
fair. Child.
I can't relate to that.
You're still tired. It's the same feeling.
Yeah.
So actually, like, Cody might agree that maybe, Cody, do you ever see anybody that's like 25 being like, man, I'm getting old? And you're like, you don't even fucking know.
No.
So that's kind of what I'm getting at. That's kind of my point is like, in like the later part of my 20s, people were like, oh, I'm getting old. And like, I don't feel old at all. But, and you feel old, but you have a reason to.
Yeah.
And which you shouldn't, by the way. You're not old.
Kid,
you're not
old. Marriage, I'm happy.
But you're not fucking old. But so point is, you definitely do feel similarly the way that I feel about it. Because you see people saying like, I feel so old. And you're like, why?
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
I will say young people are way too loud. Like,
way too loud.
No, now you're old.
Yes. Now you're old.
No. Wait till go ahead. Keep going.
No, you agree?
I agree. These young kids need to shut the fuck up.
I went to a restaurant. There was music outside, and there's this fucking loud people going. Bah!
Okay, I have neighbors that are below us. So.
Well, that was really quick.
Okay.
And also, was that supposed to be a piano?
No, they
were
just.
It was
like,
a piano bar. You freak?
No, they were
just playing bongos.
Was this at a Rainforest Cafe or a dinosaur?
It was
or what?
A Rainforest Cafe. No, it was outside in Pasadena. There was a jazz band playing like Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin music, and they're just like. Bum, 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 and like dancing by their table. I'm like, fucking sit down, listen to the music, eat your fucking burger.
Mm. Yeah, eat your vegetables, you whore.
That's it. Just shut the fuck up.
Yeah, Brian.
That's what I say.
Brian
on cocaine, dude.
Yeah. What?
Brian's fucking old.
Yeah, he is.
He is
you
old.
Should feel old.
Just fucking listen to the music. You don't have to fucking make a scene.
I think Brian's been like this since he was 21, though.
What a sad life you live, you piece of shit.
What are you, dancing into your table?
I'm going to dance. I'm going to take my shoes off and get tetanus on the fucking street, sweetheart.
You dance, you go to the fucking strip club and go dance.
And you get tetanus.
No, you don't dance at the strip club, you fucking lunatic.
You can do whatever you want in the champagne room.
Wait a minute, I want
to
go.
Comes to you.
Yeah.
I want to go into a strip club and slow dance.
Yes. If you pay for it, you can do it in the champagne room. You do that.
Wait, you're saying pay for it in the champagne room? Oh, God. That is fucking terrifying. That is serial killer behavior. Hey, do you do private dances? I want to go to the champagne room. And then you're like, I want to slow dance with you for 30 minutes.
That's what you just said.
Can I?
No, I meant I want to go in with someone else and slow dance. And now I'm not talking about with the dancers.
I just want a private room to dance with somebody.
I want a private dance.
Yeah.
I was going to say real quick.
May I have this dance? No, go ahead.
Christian,
have some confidence. Go ahead.
Nah, come on. Have some confidence for once in your life.
I was going to say, Cody and I are in a group chat with our good friend Robbie Smith.
Oh, yeah.
And he sent us a message recently. I don't know if I could.
One of those photos are we allowed to show the audience?
But he Robbie was specifically.
It's all dick.
I don't know if this is bad, if I should mention it, or I don't know if I have consent from him.
Mm. Careful, man. Flawless episode. Don't fuck it up.
But he mentioned me, Gramp Cody, stamp. And Brian specifically. Do you remember that one?
No.
No, you have to figure that you can't set this up and not end on this.
Ask it again.
Show it over. Show it over here.
All right.
Yeah, take a look. Is this okay?
Yeah, you think that's okay?
Sure.
Oh, sure.
I don't know.
I didn't read it.
Do we just go out on it and say nothing? Just hit the music when he's done?
Okay, here we go.
No comment.
Robbie says, I may or may not have been had a conversation with a mutual friend where I allegedly referred to Christian. Christian as the handsome one.
No comment.
Christian as the handsome one. Cody having a mighty kickstand. And Brian growing up to be a hot serial killer.
Oh. Take us home, Robbie.
Oh, shit.
That's how he views us.
There's more to it, but I didn't want to read that.
Oh.
That's a good ending. I like that. I like that.
I think Robbie dun, 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 dun.
Wow, what if I have the balls to do this as a karaoke song?
Dun, 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 dun.
Dun, 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 dun.
10-minute version.
Hey, that was
Taylor
so much fun.
Style.
Thank you guys for having me on.
Thank you.
What a blast.
Thank you.
And thank you to Kat.
Thanks, Kat.
Thank you to Kat. That was great. Speaking of Taylor Swift style.
Thank you to Kat. Thank you to Eric. Thank you to Robbie.
Thank you to Kat for mansplaining to us men about Taylor Swift.
I didn't know about that.
I didn't know about it.
Yeah, we learned.
We learned about Taylor Swift.
We learned a lot.
Are people still listening? Did everybody have fun out there?
Yeah. No, this is the end.
I want to see in the chat. Do you guys have fun?
This is where they can click the end cards. You can check out more episodes of the podcast. You can check out our short film, Grandma.
Oh, we didn't talk about that. Grandma's your best work in fucking forever.
Whoa.
It's so good. I love it.
Oh, all right. Let's talk about it.
Yeah, here we go.
No, we don't have to talk about it. I loved it. We'll talk about it next time. I loved it.
Go watch that. Subscribe to our channel. Join the Patreon. Thank you all so much. We love you all. One love. All love. Quest love. Bye.
Bye.